jam, pump it up while your feet are stumping. And the jam is pumping, look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at.
And finally, with Blaine Canada from South Park, Bigger, Longer, and Uncut, please welcome Academy Award winner Robin Williams.
Oh my God, they killed Kenny! Times have changed, our kids are getting worse. They won't obey their parents, they just wanna fart and curse. Should we blame the government, or blame society? Or should we blame the images on TV? Now, blame Canada! Things gone wrong since Canada came along.
Blame Canada! Blame Canada!
We need to form a full assault. Don't blame yourself for your son Stan. He saw the darn cartoon and now he's off to join the clan. And my boy Eric once had my picture on his shelf, but now when he sees me, he tells me to f*** myself.
Blame Canada! Blame Canada!
Because when Canada is gone, there'll be no North to lead the earth.
Blame Canada! Blame Canada!
They're not even a real country anyway. Kenny could have been a doctor or a lawyer, rich and true. Instead, he burned up like a piggy on the barbecue. Should we blame the nurses? Should we blame the fire? The doctors who allowed him to expire? Heck no!
Blame Canada! Blame Canada!
With all their hockey hullabaloo and that bitch Anne Marie too.
Blame Canada!
Blame Canada! All I can say is I give up. It's Canada's fault. Everybody!
Were good, so I thought. Then you ran off with your boss, keyed my truck, slashed my tires. Then you set my clothes on fire. Didn't want you to leave, I'm not gonna lie. Started to cry, but then remembered I could take myself fishing. In my hand, enjoy the quiet for hours, or go hang with my friends. I can do self-romancing, yeah. All I need is my hand, and I can leave the seat up on the cake.
Thank you. mean, there is, when you made that intro, there is a smile or a frowny face for the chat.
I'm gonna need a drink. There we go.
There it is. So welcome to the chat. The day has come to see if the bird was right or wrong for his fandom. For is Kelsey
bird
Shannon.
The word. Just,
bird is the word.
Everyone's turning on me. What's going on?
That is what we're doing. We have made it to the Hillbilly Book Club. Before we get into that, though, we got some stuff to go over with the chat. First, let's go look at our calendar, which we're going to be doing a lot of work on for the second quarter today. I already picked our hiatus dates, a.k.a. the CG implosion dates. So we're doing Dank Fang. We're picking books for our next quarter today. So that would be the chat reads, where we read a CG book together, and then the Hillbilly Book Club, where we read CGers' mainstream work or their previous work. We'll also be voting.
Didn't we already choose the CG book?
No. We always do it at the end of the Hillbilly
No, I'm pretty sure we chose Cable.
We did Cable.
Did we?
You forgot already.
Dang! All right. I was thinking we still had a second one, but we already did Cable. Showed you how memorable that was, huh?
Oof. Yeah.
All right, let's go.
We'll be doing the Sandwich Saturday voting, so you still have time to get sandwiches in. I forget. Let's go.
At least this is memorable chat, this one that I have.
The Dank Fang? Yeah.
Actually, I forgot a good chunk of it.
Sandwich Saturday winner. So the winner of this Sandwich Saturday will be 1v1ing Snuggless. Will be 1v1ing this Snuggless sandwich to see who the winner is for March of 2024. So that is what we'll be doing today. So Vanessa's getting on these polls today. Oh, and then next weekend, it's Easter weekend, and there was 5 Saturdays in March, and I needed a schedule hiatus anyway. So next weekend, we're going to be on hiatus, because there's no way, as Christian, as some members of CG claim themselves to be, there's no way we're going to have any issues on the week leading up to Easter. None.
Mm. Nope.
None. Whatsoever.
People are gonna they're gonna pack their bags and go on home.
They're gonna be like, we need to plan to have Easter lunch or dinner with somebody. We need to go to church.
Yeah.
We have to get the good church clothes.
100%. You ceasefire.
I have my family coming to my house for like the first time. Be my dad, my brother, and my sister-in-law. The
kids are
still away. Considering I have 400 boxes of cookies set around my house right now, not really. And working 6 days a week, my house definitely could use some TLC. And you want to know the kicker? I still have my Christmas decorations sitting in my living room.
Oh, yeah. But they're not outside. That's fine.
No, they're in the totes, but I need to move the totes to the garage.
Oh, okay. I thought you I still have them up.
I'm no,
like,
I don't
it's
have
March. Them. What do you mean you still have them up?
I just have the totes sitting in my living room.
Okay. So let's go say hello to the chat before we get all of this started. So it's Dank Fang Day is here. We have made it. Can I declare March 23rd to be Dank Fang Day? Am I allowed to do that? Ellie is here, and he put 2 Draculas in the thing. Prater 7 was here earlier saying, what's up? Maromi was here earlier. So was Snuggy saying, new stream, who dis? You should know who this is. Angela Curry says, you love me, you really love me. Michael Dice was here earlier. If Stippling is still wearing that dang hat. Well, Stippling ain't here. But the bird got the hat. So, good looking out, bird.
Yep. I figured I hadn't made everybody in the chat lose faith in me. So, there's 2 more. I got it.
Passmaster Dan is speaking French up in here. Let's see here. Omer Glitch is going on. Beastman says, how dare Graham Nolan schedule his closeout party during the chat? By the way, how is it a party? It's a party if you make it a party. There was a time in Comicsgate where we just needed the loosest excuse to celebrate. Now, mm-hmm. now we got to the point of our adulthood chat. We're just like, eh, how's it a party? What type of bullshit is this? With that deep smoker voice. Ah, these fucking kids, get off my freaking driveway. Like, I don't know what happened to us. You remember those days, Amanda, we would all stay up for random closeout?
Yep.
Now we're like, ah, fuck it. Screw you.
That was forever ago. So we're
where's my now. Comic book? Yeah. Sound like we have emphysema. and need to have freaking the little trachea where you sound like a robot, like, eh. Jav is here. Cicerone says, justice for the 20 minutes of my life lost. Your 20 minutes are not lost. You know where they are. They were spent. I would think wisely. But of course, you could disagree. Maromi is reporting that fulfillment for Black and White 2 is finally happening just in time for the Lord's second coming. I'm not gonna say any more than that. Genuine Comics says hello, and we say hello. Mugen One is in this here chat. It's always good to have Mugen One here. Henry Bemis is here. Let's see who else has showed up. Omer Glitch is here. Always good to have Omer. And then Cicerona says, blame Stato. Blame Stato. That's what he said. That's what he said. I mean, I can't take that.
I know, man. He took it real personally, this thing. I got yelled at by Amanda.
I know. Page 2, I'm in the DM. Stato.
Clutch Boogie is here saying, hail to chat. Mike TV Doug says, Canada, honk, honk, freedom truck trucks. Freedom truckies. We need to liberate poutine, though. Although it's a heart attack on a plate. Mm-hmm. Like, yep. Literally. Michael DJ says, Statch reputation hinges on our opinion of his selection. Dank Fang.
I'm going to get fired from the show for sure. Now, thanks a lot.
I know. A-Line is here.
Wait a minute. I know. Everybody.
Michael Bancroft says, where's the leprechaun hat? I mean, Stat, throw the hat back on.
Okay. On it.
There it is. He says this is BS, but I mean, clearly, Statistical Lead Zero has the hat.
Yep. Stole it right off his head.
Yep. Travco says the chat, the one last shining light. One of the last shining lights in the dark. Don't put that on. Don't put your hope in Comicsgate on this show. Don't do that. Don't do it. Don't you know about the bird? The bird is the word. Yeah, the chat was for 33% happy. Really?
With the book? Yeah, probably.
All right. So I'm going to... DJ, I see your comment under that or near that. I'm going to star that for later because you're starting to talk about the book. Snuggy, this is a borderline chill. So is this.
Wasn't that first one our sponsor, though?
On Saturday show.
Sponsor. Yeah.
Isn't that the Saturday show? Sponsor the show?
I mean, we this are the official, unofficial Broken. Home of the Rocafort. So, like, yeah. Borderline, but I'll allow it. B-Spin is Vanessa sick like every other week? No, I feel great. This is just my regular voice. Although people were saying on Wednesday that they didn't know how they felt about my NPR voice.
Mm.
Because I was talking like this chat because it was early in the morning. It was 1 o'clock in the morning my time and I couldn't just yell.
That was a good time.
Project my voice into my apartment in my old house apartment where we could hear each other. Like,
what if you got like a box that's like soundproof, you could stick it on your head right? Stick the microphone in there, like a little hole in the side, you know, like
you
like
know how much those box. Things cost? They, those
you could probably make it. Just like tape a bunch of egg cartons together and stick it on your head.
That's not how this works. Bancroft says cable must have been great, Amanda. Dang, the chat. Go get her chat.
Although, when I think about it, I do remember bits and pieces of it. And if I read it, I wouldn't have read it months before we were supposed to read it. So, okay, we did go over it. I believe yes. You.
So, not only did I get notification, I had a hell of a time finding the show. It's here. Unless we're Welcome. On a hiatus, the show is here.
You made it.
All right, everybody's saying hello. Old Dirty Fatty says, darn it, now I want cookies. You still have time, right? They still have time to order cookies?
If you
want to
do an order online, yep.
Okay. Michael DJ says, I smell the dank. Dank Fang.
You guys don't have cookies that get you out of trouble with a large group of people, do you?
Well, they're kind of like, you know, meat with dogs. You kind of throw the cookies down and the people will
and then you run.
Oh, okay, cool. Yeah. That's good to know.
So Beastman said, bless the bird, shakes fist. Mm-hmm. Richie Dupe says, hail the chat. And we say, hail to you back, sir.
That's a hailstorm.
It's a hailstorm. Where's that gift for Natra? I had to get another girlfriend due to lack of streams. Shake my head. Where's that gift for Natra? I had to get another girlfriend due to lack of streams. What do you mean lack of streams? I feel like everybody's freaking streaming now. There's a lot of daytime streams now. I wonder what happened to nighttime with Comicsgate. They're just like
they're getting old.
Yeah, people are sleeping now.
Maddie has a day show now. I was like, what in the world?
Wait, who had the day show?
Mandy Summers. All the hostages have been released. Maromi, you can't do this on my show. We talked about this. Oh, my goodness.
He must have read Dank Fang and just didn't have a heart for it anymore. Just like, jeez. You know what? Just open the door and let him out.
Yep. Bancroft says, Stato. You're making me so mad-o, Stato. Amanda, probably. I think that was a direct quote.
Yeah, that sounds like the DMs.
Yep. Carbon Heart is here saying, here we go to save the day. Henry Bemis says that Snuggy is shill adjacent. He every now and then you have to have a snuggless in your chat that's willing to push the envelope to see where his boundaries are. Because he's a growing boy, and he just needs to see if somebody will be like, no, this is my boundary. And he's like, okay. Carbon Heart says he prefers the quiet voice. Well, it's not. Unfortunately, it's Saturday, 5 in the 5 o'clock hour in the p.m. for me, and not like 1 o'clock in the morning. Jim Clark says, speaking of Shilly, will there be a sumo wrestling on Leroy's channel tonight? R.I.P. Leroy. Well, I mean, when the time of the show comes, Jim, don't forget to put that link in the chat. Mm-hmm. Clutch Boogie says he prefers the NPR voice. Noted. I'll remember that for my 6-month HR review with you, chat. I don't know which one of you are going to play the part of the HR officer, but obviously we need to talk about that. Okay, so Omar Glitch says Vanessa has 1-900 1-900 talking dirty in the middle of the night. No, I wish I did, actually. I have student loans to pay off of. CG's transition to Cookie Gate was so gradual I didn't even notice. I mean, everybody needs to notice some cookies.
If not Cookie Gate, Puzzle Gate.
Puzzle Gate, yep. Omer Glitch says, Trash Cas has taken over like everything. It's hard to keep track of all these streams. So Bancroft says, yeah, Trash Cas pretty much owns the night time slot now.
No, it's a great opportunity to like stream against it because there are quite a few people that don't like that stuff. So they will go to your show if it's going in there. I mean,
yeah,
it's the truth.
It says he owns the night. I'm sure EVS, somebody should tell EVS he's, you know, he's no longer a Dutch boy. He's a boy from Transylvania now. He owns the night. Eric the Guapo is here. All right. So, and then Snuggy says, pretty awesome that comic streams are now overshadowed by a former, okay, you're not going to get me in trouble right before a hiatus. It's a John is still kind of sour for some reason.
Is he?
Yeah. I watched back, I had to remember because it was December. And I was watching back when you picked the Dank Fang, and then that show was talking about like how he was gonna give out courtesy copies of Graveyard Shift,
mm-hmm.
And he was like, "Give me your addresses," and he tagged a whole bunch of people to include me, uh-huh. And I was like, "No, thank you." I don't know. Maybe he took that, and maybe he didn't take that well. I don't know.
Who doesn't like free comics? He says to himself.
I don't know, like she doesn't want free comics. What? Travco says Bancroft's another light in the dark. Butthurt YouTubers get old. Okay, so I had to read this real quick. EVS is a ball hogger. He's making money hand over fist with trash cast. He's on a poll, if you will. It's just his poll is live streaming, and that's fine. Carbonheart says, what's your beef with John? I don't have a beef with John. Well, I have fun with it at this point. There was one time a couple years ago where he hurt my feelings about the award show because he wasn't nominated for nothing that year. Although he won something. I think that was our third or fourth award show.
Uh-huh.
And after that, I'm kind of like, I know what to expect now. Know what to expect now. Voss Dugu says, stop hurting John's fifis. Well, I learned that you're not supposed to have emotions on the internet. So if he has emotions on the internet, that's on him. I don't have emotions on the internet. Michael DJ says, Rob Arner will swoop in and dominate this space. You heard it here first. This space? Mike TV, Ethan on the pole. What a nauseating image. Well, I mean, throw those donos at him. You turned down free books to act all cool. I turned down all free books. He's not the first one to ask for, you know, to offer me a reader copy. So I don't do it to look cool. Like, I'll pay for the books I'm interested in. Okay, Amanda, are you ready?
I'm like, for what? No, but yes. Hang on. Sorry. I was refreshing my memory with Dank Fang. I will get there. I promise.
Imagine chat, that I'm killing time. I'm saying hello to you. She knows she's next. 23 minutes later.
Wait. You ready? There were no show notes. How do I know I'm next?
Oh, snap.
Technicality. You know approximately the order of this show.
Game in the system.
All right. Your screen is shared.
All right. So these are in order of what's been out the longest, actually, because that's how I put it in. Okay. So just like 6 days ago, whatever, Unconditional Shove Second Chance launched on Fund My Comic. It has, $1 goal. So it's made its goal.
Oh, well.
Thanks.
I mean, that's one way to do it.
Yep. Also launching, I want to say, whoops. Actually, no, this is closing. Sorry, this is closing. I got these out of order. I failed already. All right, this one's closing. 7 days left. Perfect 10, the artist edition. So it's oversized. I think they're going with a hardcover of just the first issue, which this is one of my favorite IPs. So if you're interested, definitely check that out. Opening a few days ago, Butch Cleaver 1 and 2 for a second chance with Matt Burke. Unfortunately, has not gotten any backers. So please check this out. If it's not for you, even if it is for you, share it out because Matt can definitely use some love on this one. Also, that launched this week, a little campaign called Groken 3.
Yep. Before you change over, for anybody. For anybody who is here when we did the, I guess, the launch stream, I guess that's what we could call that. Thank you for showing up. You know, we had a good amount of people in there for the time of day that we're doing that. So I appreciate you. Kenneth, appreciate you. But the job is not done, Rocaforce. We have to hit that six-figure young lady. So we need to go forth and let people know and discover that they too are Rocaforcians. Because imagine, Bird, there are comic book readers who do not know that they are indeed a part of the Rocaforce.
You're going to go door-to-door with pamphlets, do you think?
Yes, and I'm just like, have you heard of the good news of Grokin? All right, go ahead, Amanda.
Romy's asking about original art. Is he talking about Grokin?
All the art
is gone, I believe.
Yeah, and I was able to actually get a sketch this time, you heathens.
You did?
Yeah, I didn't get the 500, the Grokin sketch. I got the sketchbook sketch. I was able to get
that. Really wasn't much price. Vanessa, I told you. Now I feel bad. All right, moving on. Blood Realm opened, what, 3 days ago, 2 days ago? The day after Grokin. That's what we're going to refer to it as.
Oh, Thursday, then.
Right. Robert Geronimo has a $10,000 goal. Not quite there yet. He's only halfway, but, you know, he's 3 days in. This is, what did you say, issues like 14 through 18, Stato?
Mm-hmm. 15, 16, 17, 18, something like that. Yeah.
It's quite high up there. So he's well vested in the series. So if you haven't, I'm sure the beginning ones are at alterna.com. And then this is the continuation set.
Mm-hmm. I think he's got back issues on there you can get as well. If I remember right, you can get a bunch of back issues.
Well, and be mindful of like the Alterna model, if you will. If these campaigns don't make their goal, they don't go to print. That's just the model. Mm-hmm. So if why are you laughing?
I'm reading Omer's comments. Okay.
Don't read Omer Glitch's comments. Obviously, he's throwing you off. So if it's something that interests you, I mean, with all these campaigns, but if it's something that interests you, especially Alterna campaigns, you want to support those before they end their funding period. All right, continue. Doing great.
Also launching this past week, Downcast 4 Hunting Ground. This is a second chance as well. He is going to print very soon, so he's trying to get any stragglers if there are any, and I think says June 2024, so he's just trying to get some stragglers. He has made gold, of course.
That's a topic idea. Continue.
And closing this week, the only one that I'm aware of, and I did put out a tweet to see if anybody else knew of any, and actually nobody even suggested this one. What is wrong with CG Twitter? Come on now. All right. So yes, Graham is on another channel doing his little close out because he is not 9 hours.
Why did you call it little? It's a gigantic. It's a gigantic Graham Nolan size closeout.
A parquet.
It's a monster size closeout. It should still be going when we're done. Please don't run away from us, chat.
With 8 hours left, made $100,000. What was the stretch? Stippling was going on about a stretch goal in the DM.
It was a little
extra story, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
The cigars, something?
Kirby Cigars, name of the story, yep.
Kirby Cigars. So this is closing out in 8 hours. Not sure if he's going in demand or not. I can't say I remember his MO. I think he usually does go into in demand, doesn't he? For a bit.
For a bit.
And that is it, unless I am forgetting any. So... you over. So unless I'm forgetting anything, put it in the chat. All right.
So Richie Dupe says my emotions are suspended in a fleshy sack. I don't want to think more about that.
Got to hang it in a tree, you know, like so the bears don't get it.
But he said, never mind. We're gonna. Henry Bemis says, imagine actually having integrity. Omar Gluch says, yeah, that year that John got in his fifis hurt, he was a real a-hole most of the year. LOL, John has chilled out this last year. Well, that's wonderful. My team is up. I'll admit, I threw some sip bucks at Ethan for trash cast. I mean, I've done it in the past, too. He works hard for his money. So hard for it, honey. Yeah, because he's freaking been doing them a long streams. Whole, like, anything over 3 hours, chat, I'm like, you're a marathon runner. And then don't be like Finatra and do like a 15-hour stream. I'm like, what? Those streams are painful. I mean, we're getting closer and closer to award season. I'm thinking about like a three and a half hour, four hour stream. I'm like, oh God, I don't want to do it. Ellie says, Rage Against the V Machine, Amanda, most deaf. I know Amanda, she be raging in the back. She'll be like, I'm not taking this shit from you, Vanessa. Old Dirty Fatty says, we're not joking. Go get broken. I mean, I think we are the fan club here. So you need to go forth and go out. Go to the streets. Not just the internet streets, the actual streets. Go into your local comic book store. As long as you're not having previously been kicked out and have a restraining order, go to your local comic book store and talk about the goodness of Groken and the Rogue Force. Michael Bancroft says, I'll totally buy a Rogue Force signature and I'm a pin so people know I'm Rogue Force. Oh, like I'm with those election pins. Henry Bemis says, Vanessa's going to form a new religion called Canis Witness. Well, I mean, if the Great Spaghetti Monster could be a legitimate religion in the United States, why not? What's happened to the gleaming the cube? Is it more like dragging ass to the gut these days? What in the world, Richie Dupe, are you talking about? I don't understand. Bird, do you understand this one?
I don't.
Clutch Boogie says Amanda's changing campaigns because she's a Rook of Fourth. Dang. Is that what we're going to call Amanda, Rook of Fourth?
Whoa.
Thanks.
Vaughn Stugel is just letting the chat know that Downcast is a top five, if not top three book. I'm doing Downcast. Maromi says, I'm still waiting for the Ghost of Manicumbe. I don't back until I receive the prior campaign. You may want to email. Well, he said he's currently fulfilling that. So maybe it's just a matter of time. Just a matter of time. Let's see here. Anybody else say anything? What's wrong with your friend Snuggles here, Amanda?
Plenty wrong with Snuggy.
Oh, snap.
It's more. No. Less. I'm a lady of the streets. Omer Glitch, I support you. Let's see here. Is the bird yawning? Yeah, are you bored, bird?
No.
Okay.
Maybe. Not Maybe. Bored. Just tired. Went on a long walk with Mrs. Stat and the Mutt.
Oh, nice.
Okay. Cold air.
Cold relaxing. Air. And you're a little bird, and she's little a full-size adult human, so you're like, you're effectively running.
Yeah.
Why is Stat in jail? Everybody throw a few bucks in for bail. For
yeah,
a bail
I'm going to throw anything but bricks.
Not tonight. He can Not stay tonight. In jail.
I got put in the doghouse with Amanda here.
Oh my goodness, that was so victim. Funny.
I'm a victim of circumstance.
He's a victim of his fandom, of his love for Kelsey Shannon.
True.
All right. And then Omer Glitch says, give the Burke some crack. You understand this is the bird regular.
Yeah.
As he is right now. This is pure 100% Stat. You wanna
Yep, uncut.
You wanna add crack to that? That's already we already have the bird. Notice how we only have one bird on this show.
One bird.
One bird. This is a one bird show. And now you want to add crack into the formula? No, we're good. And then Citizen Ronan says jail builds character. You know, also builds character. Dank Fang. Dank Fang.
Character, or it assassinates in my case.
We're building some character with this here Dank Fang. All right. So we are now transitioning.
Oh boy.
Transitioning to a comedy show. While we talk about a book called Dark Fang Volume 1, Earth Calling by Miles Gunther.
That sounds weird now when you say it right.
Yes. Miles Gunther and Kelsey as the writer, and Kelsey Shannon as the artist, like the complete artist. He did it. He did all the art.
Have we heard any comments from Mr. Shannon in regards to this piece of work? Like, did he enjoy writing it? I'm not writing it. Did he enjoy doing the art? Was the process cool? Did he?
Amanda,
we haven't heard much from Kelsey written lately at all.
I mean, but it's an older book. It's what, 2017? Well, how old is this?
I think he just said something like, "I hope you like it."
I mean, I liked some of, I loved the parts of it.
2018.
I'm trying to think. He said something when he found out we were going to, this was like 2 months ago. He's like, oh man. He was laughing about it.
Dank Fang.
It was an awkward laugh, wasn't it?
Because he didn't, he was like, what's Dank Fang? And then we explained, you know, it's
Dark Fang. And then he was like, oh.
He said, oh, that's the street name. He started laughing.
It's Dank Fang. On these here streets. So, chat, do we need to have a... No, we don't. Because I didn't clip it, even though I do have it. I actually did chapters on that freaking show. That is hilarious. That December show, we're like, oh, dang, Dark Fang, Volume 1, I'm getting it. Then we read it. Then we read it. All right.
I had high hopes, too, because... Michael Dice was like, hey, issue one's really good. I'm excited to get into number two.
That was what she had issue with. I'm in trouble.
You're in trouble. All right. So let's go get started. We'll be using the same format we do for all the book clubs. So
I'll go into number one since it's fresh because I just did it.
All right. So Stato, why did you back Dark Fang?
Ain't nobody backed Dark Fang. This came out from Image.
Well, come on. Come on now. Why did you get Dank Fang?
Because I was forced to because of this show.
Don't lie to
us. Wait, who forced you?
don't lie to us, Berg. I have it all. You know, we may have to do this. Hold on. I have to do a... Let me pull up YouTube. Because I do
have it. You
gotta
replay the vote?
I am going to replay...
The moment
that Stato got us to Dank Fang,
I got beat up. Does anyone have sympathy for me?
No, there's no sympathy for you, obviously. Live.
I can't believe it.
Where is it? So it was in Jan. It was.
Look at these people. How many buses am I going to get put? It's almost like it's school's out and the buses are pulling away and I'm kicked under every single one of them by the chat.
Okay. We are going to relive together this moment where Dank Fang became a thing for us all. Go make sure the volume is cranked up. All right.
Dark Fang with Kelsey Shannon art.
Hold on. How Dark Fang?
Dark Fang, yeah.
Fang, Kelsey.
Never heard of it, but it's on my wish list now. Oh man, that's what I sound like.
Yes. Is it collected? Dark Fang.
Yeah, it's 120 pages.
Oh, collected. Dark Fang cover price $9.99. Why is my YouTube rebelling against my
Because
will?
It knows it doesn't want to play this.
Like it knows it doesn't want to incriminate you, Stat.
Mm-hmm.
Omer Glitch says water vampires. Well, then put on the list.
That on the list.
Put that on the list.
can get it even if it doesn't win the vote.
How do you feel about that laugh now, Stat?
Oh, that, I was laughing at me, I guess, from the future.
Just Perth says you're double guilty.
Dang.
Omerglitch says vampire mermaids. It gets better, Omerglitch, once YouTube wants to do its thing.
Yeah, YouTube doesn't need to do its thing. It's fine.
Dark Fang, Volume 1. Kelsey. Her name is Vala. She's a vampire who has resided on the bottom of the ocean for a century. Bitch, what are you doing all under all that water? When her aquatic... You know what? We can't do this. YouTube.
Yeah, that's right. We can't do this.
It's still you, Bert. It was still you.
Yeah, but the chat voted on it. Where's their culpability? Where is their
they were laughing. They were being the chat did what the chat was supposed to do.
They could have voted on the other ones. I told them not to. They didn't listen to me. See, let it be known. Let the record show, which it was there. You can go back and check the tape. I said, don't do it. Don't vote for that one. I said, that's what I said.
Yeah, and of course they're like, we're definitely voting for this one now. I'll go stop sharing. Let me get my Kindle up. Where is my Kindle?
I'm dragging all of y'all under the bus with me.
Where are my orders?
So I went with a hard copy of it. I know you guys both went digital.
It's going to be worse for you.
Yeah. I know.
At
least I got the physical prettiness. You know what I mean?
That's true. You get the art. Yeah, I was going to say otherwise. You know, like, you have bonfires up there? Like,
we have gotten a snowstorm all day.
There you go. So you're going to need that. Stippling, Vaughn, you.
What, is he in
here? Blame the chat on my outro. He's in the chat. He's in the chat. He's not even on here. If anyone shouldn't have showed up, it should have been me. I'm even wearing your hat.
Everybody's here we go. Give me Dank Fang.
I'm getting cornered. I'm gonna have to start striking.
All right. View this order. Give me Dank Fang. You can really make me pull my password in here. Hey, Amazon.
Yeah.
What? View my books. Jesus. Why is everything a living hell? Stop it.
Know.
Give me Dank Fang. Open. Read now. Okay. Jesus. Should not take that long. So it's basically, as a reminder, this is the bird's fault.
Oh, come on.
No, the chat did what the chat's
kind
supposed
of my,
to do.
It's kind of my fault,
You got to a point where, like, oh, he
I'll
he
accept
did this,
the responsibility.
Made a
I made a mistake.
Made
where's
a
the forgiveness?
Mistake.
Where's the, what do we call it? Forgiveness is a good one. The forgetting, moving on.
We forgive water you, but we ain't forgetting this. The next time you come across a Kelsey Shan, you're like, "Ooh, Kelsey Shan," but like we're gonna be like, read the description first,
right? Whoa! Don't pull the trigger yet.
Read the description first, Sato.
Oh boy, I should have. Yeah.
Oh my goodness, Old Dirty Fatty says I'm on Team Seed Eater. I like eating seeds.
See, he's in my corner.
All right.
Look at him and Bemis.
Omerglitch says, this looks really cool. Dang, I miss the Sasquatch. He phased out of our dimension currently. He's trying to do, what, like 4 or 5?
Yeah.
Projects?
He's got a ton of work that he's working on.
All right. So Henry Bemis says, that's it. I'm mailing Stat a loaf of bread with a file in it.
Attaboy.
He's trying to break you out. And Jav says, remember suggesting RGD's book for other reviews because the ding dent was only $10 as well as shipping next day. Well, we're gonna get on that poll. We're gonna get on that one towards the end.
Perth Comics right. Just Schwarzeneggered me. I can't believe it.
Let's see here. All right. So who wants to do story overview?
I'll do one. And I suppose if you want to take the time, like after a fresh exactly what I don't know. There's
a lot
in here.
Are you talking about the first issue?
The first issue. There's a lot in here.
Okay, let me do the broad strokes, and then we could get into the story. So, this is Vala, which They don't say her freaking name. Yeah, they don't say her freaking name until the end of the book. So I don't know why they're putting that as the her name is Vala. It's like, you guys are retarded. Do you not have an editor's image?
That's going to set the tone for the second half of this story.
Yeah, you're going to just put her stuff out there. So what it is that we have a vampire who is just living her best vampire life. Once upon a time, she was just a little girl in a village. She gets bit by Dracula. Then Dracula and his three wives make her a slave in their castle. And then eventually she kills all of them. She just turns. And then she goes into the water. She goes into this here water. And she makes friends. And I'm surprised that Stippling Vaughn is not here to show feelings about friends. She makes friends with a shark.
Yeah, see, I did him a favor.
She made friends with a shark, and that was her bestie. And then she just found a sucking ships, and she was she was basically just doing her thing for 100 years. And then this black shit came out of somewhere, and it killed her friend. So the rest of this book, the rest of the series, is about revenge for her best shark friend, who died because of this black shit.
I brought you all good art.
Yeah. With, you know, all sorts of other story. But that's the basically thing. Vala comes back. We killed her shark. I'm John Wicking Vala real quick, aren't I? You killed my shark. You shouldn't have killed my freaking shark. I'm going to kill all of you. So that's basically, she goes up to the surface to try to find out what the heck is going on, and she's poisoned, and it becomes a thing. There's a whole bunch of stuff that happens. So that is the broad strokes. Amanda, you don't want to do broad strokes, though.
No. I was just going to go on the first one, but you basically described the first one, and then the everything else is the revenge. So yeah. She goes up, well, actually, in the beginning story, she goes up into trying to get revenge, gets acclimated back into the world that's, you know, 100 years after she was a little girl, and sees that everybody has their heads planted in devices and phones. And she ends up taking out this guy who's watching Chatterbait. I don't really know. Something Chatterbait-is. And so she picks up the phone and starts watching it and is amused by the fact that this girl is getting money showing off her bits and stuff like that. So she finds someone that basically helps her to become a chatterbait girl so she can get money. And she uses her vampire powers to convince them through the internet to send her money. So she becomes rich beyond whatever and buys Dracula's castle.
Which is the castle she was a slave in. Going full circle.
And then, so I think that's
please defend yourself on this.
This chat's
who doesn't
hilarious.
Know about Chatterbait?
I have no idea what that is. I've heard that
what?
Expression.
I have no idea what that is either.
You hang out with kids.
Chatterbait, I thought that was like a place where they like lure you in with conversation. You know, like,
yeah,
have some chatter and here's the bait.
Anyways, moving on.
So it's like a buy me, drink me girl, but in a chat. See, now
what?
Amanda doesn't know what buy me, drink me girl is.
Now, what? There, no, see, I don't know what that is.
There it is. We equal out. Like, I don't know what Chatterbait is. Amanda doesn't know what a buy me, drink me girl is.
Is it like a YouTube kind of thing for cam girls or something? Is that what?
No, it's a thing in Okinawa. It is what it sounds like. It's a young Okinawan woman who works at a bar. And she go, buy me drink. And she sucks in these lonely, lonely Marines and airmen to buy overpriced drinks in hopes of some romantic entanglement that will not happen under the careful watch of her mama-san.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. And Jab Styler says, and this is the part of the story that still makes kind of sense.
The first issue did.
This, yeah, this part wasn't, it was weird, but it wasn't as weird as it gets. Mm-hmm. But I was like, when the girl picks up the phone and wants to become the, you know, girl that gets the tokens, I'm like, what kind of a book are we watching? Or, you know, or not watching, but reading. And I'm like, because it's page
okay,
two.
You can watch it. The art's good. You don't need to read it.
Yeah, you just can't look at it. Like, ignore these boxes and ovals. Just look at the art.
Right. Like, and that headless guy is a guy that's helping her do the internet stuff. He's the internet genius, but I guess she got mad and chopped his head off.
He reminds me, I know this is way before it, but he reminds me of that one. I don't know if you guys have seen that that show at all, that What We Do in Shadow, the Shadow Show. There's a time vampire. Like, he just wastes your time and feeds off of it, sucks the time away. He looks reminds me a lot of that dude.
Not familiar.
All right, so let me take a pause to get the chat. Michael DJ said, yes, issue one had me wanting to continue. My test passed. Sister Rose says, the art is... We're not on art, so we're going to go skip all the art stuff. Art. There you go. Michael DJ, she's naked. Shit happens. The end. Actually, that's a fair one.
It sums it
up. That's an art. So Sister Rona says in Maine, it's child debate. And then Omar Glitch says it's cheddar bait, all about cheese. See, those make sense to me.
That's the same thing in Wisconsin, I suppose.
Mm. Yeah. Cheddar bait. Yeah. All right, Amanda, is there... So,
well, this just kind of goes showing how, like the page before was showing how well she's, or not well, but what she's doing to manipulate these guys. That basically, you know, you have like your rich, I assumed he's oil tycoon, but who knows exactly what he is. You know, basically she's telling him to send all my money or send me your money, and then kills himself, which, you know, these are some, pretty extremes that she has these people going towards. Or there was the mafia son that took all his trust inheritance.
Yeah. What? And I know this is pre-Mange Davis, but like, I could see that.
Tracksuit.
Yeah, a tracksuit.
That's where she buys the castle.
Yep. She buys the place where she's enslaved. Which is apparently becoming a very popular thing to do in America. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I'm all for it. If your ancestors were enslaved on a plot of land and you are now an affluent young person and you decide to buy that land, I'm buy it. 100% for it. So we have to hold yourself back. Hold yourself back from talking about this one. We will talk during
that's
art.
That's art.
Yeah, we're doing... Hold it back. So this is when Dracula, she was just minding her own
business. Origin story. Yeah.
Yep. Dracula got her. She got slaved. She freaking shanked people in Dank Fang. She became friends with the ocean. That's her homie. That's her home girl. That's her BFF. And then this black shit came out of nowhere. And then she went to the top to figure out what the hell's going on. And that she's just sucking people's blood. And then she found out she got a little bit of dank on her fang. And mm-hmm. she was like, what the hell is this? And then that was the end of issue one. She got a little dank fang.
Look at that crazy cover, though.
Yeah. I mean, we're trying to hold back. I mean, we got some stuff to say about art.
Yep.
And she goes in issue two trying to figure out what happened to her tooth. So she goes back to... the Dracula's brides to see what they know. She kind of resuscitates them a little bit so they can talk to her, and they don't really give her much answers.
Yeah, they're like, she's like, where's this dank that's on my fang? And they're like, we don't know about this dank fang. They're like, we don't know nothing about no dank fang. And she was like, okay, cool. And she was like, y'all ain't never coming back. You had more time to plot. She's basically said, I can't have you plot on me. Had too much time in your hands. Think about your plots on me. Gotta go. And then she's walking up to this village. And this guy was talking about, you know, how oil rig just spilled all their dank into the water. And she's like, we can't have this dank in the water.
Well, I got that to be her old home, no? Like her fishing village? Like she went to go to her fishing village and that's the current state of her fishing village?
No? I didn't read it at that, but that's a possibility. Okay. I mean, it's possible. Or she could just been walking around and found a rando fisher village. I think it works either way, narratively.
I think there was like an oil spill at some point because he did talk about how they paid him money to move elsewhere or whatever during the cleanup. And then I think she asked like, oh, black stuff. Where did the black stuff come from? So he points out the oil rig.
Yep. And then she transforms into a shark with a dank fang. I'm getting so much mileage out of dank fang. That is hilarious. So her and her dank fang are going, went to the thing. Went to the platform and destroyed it because that's not going to release more dank into the water.
Nope.
It just magically explodes, but no extra dank has gone.
Maybe
into
it was
the ocean.
It was setting it up for like a dank fang 2 dank harder and
dank harder. Dank fang 2 electric boogaloo.
Yep.
Omer Glitch says she just needs to see a dentist. Imagine that was what it was. We could have stopped all this destruction and terror. So then she gets her homeboy to be like, I need whoever. So she saw, where the heck? Here it is. Axco or whatever. It's like, tell me who rules them. Because she's from a long time ago. She's like, who rule? Obviously, she's European.
Mm-hmm.
So she's like, who rules them? That's not even European. How can I do your... The only one I have is Italian, and it becomes a Mario. It's a Mario, Luigi, Axio, Oil. Who tell me who ruled them? Tell me this.
With is the that how you read her voice?
No.
Oh, that would have been great.
No.
I think it would improve the book.
So Von Stugel says, don't question the dankness until after issue 2.
It's true. That's when the ship started to sink.
Oh, what does this? No, I'm peeing. What the heck?
The you're European? I'm a peeing.
I'm a peeing? Okay.
European? Get it?
Yeah. Sumo Thori says, by the way, I spent half an hour trying to find a book called Dank Fang. Dank
when
Fang.
Keeping it real goes wrong.
I know. And Matt says Vanessa needs to read the audiobook as Mario. No, I don't think so. So she's like, she gets her guy in the chair, her beheaded guy in the chair to like, tell me where he, give me location. As Haviv Nurmagomedov. I butchered his last name, but he's freaking from Dagestan. You can't blame this one on me. Like Habib said, give me location. And he gives her location, and then she shows. And who put, well, was this happening in 2017 where people were doing weird stuff?
I don't know where this came from. This is an odd thing.
Why would somebody want to turn their pool into Jell-O?
Because they're rich and bored.
I mean, when you got a lot of money, you know.
You're rich and bored.
I think it was just so they could strategically place bits of Jell-O on their body.
I mean,
and
that
have
too.
It be safe for work.
Well, Kelsey could have like made longer hair, you know, on shadows or you know whatever. But I mean, yeah, I get you.
Yeah. So she now our nameless character, even though we know her name is Vala from the freaking description on the back or on the website. Is talking to the dude who owns the oil company. And she's trying to, you know, do the dirty to him. And then she hypnotizes him. And she's like, I need to know all your people who's all involved with your dank. And he's naked. The throne that. There's some naked. And then he dies in Jell-O.
Yep, she paralyzed him and threw him in.
Yep.
What a way
great
to go.
Flashbacks.
That's by Jell-O.
I mean, I think he could live. All he had to do was eat some Jell-O.
like suck it in.
Yeah, just like, ugh. See, like even old Dirty Jello Fatty shot. Was like, there's always room for Jello. Michael Dice wants us to know that he's been to a Jello wrestling party. Mm. Omer
what
Glitch
color
says,
was the Jello?
What color was the Jello? We're going to have Amanda be responsible for seeing that answer. Omer Glitch says Jello is fun. you remember when Bill Cosby used to be the spokesman for Jello?
Oh boy.
Oh, the times. J-E-L-O-O, it's alive. Who else said anything about Jello? Here
I
go.
Don't remember Sister It's Alive being part of the spokes.
It's in there.
I don't know that many people would have eaten that. There. Like, it's alive.
It's
wait,
alive.
What?
It would be sticky to nether regions. Well, I mean, you're rich and bored. Who cares?
So I
probably have 10 showers in that house.
Mm-hmm. Yep. So Jab says lots of naked dudes in that book.
Mm-hmm. Not enough.
Wait, what? Y'all yelling about page 2? I see what it is. It was
you
jealousy.
You see butt shots.
She was,
you
she
see
was
butt
like,
shots
what,
and
where's for Amanda?
Shots.
When's this Amanda going to get her art? That's
naked
what she was
ladies.
Oh, my goodness.
I get it.
You would have to be buoyant in Jello. Wouldn't you just get stuck?
I would think so. But then again, a Scrooge can swim around in coins.
Yeah, just let it. Listen, we already have a shark. We already have a vampire with a shark as a best friend. Your suspense of disbelief should be totally activated by now. Matt says Jello and naked dudes. I'm in. And then Omer Glitch says, "Dang, Manny needs to get her beef man on. Yeah, she needs a beefy man. That's not Canadian. I won't allow it, Amanda." I understand that you're from the great north, but I will not allow it. I would not. And if he just happens to be handy at a moonshine still, that's a plus. Or that maple syrup. Mm-hmm. Maple syrup. All right. So we go into 3. And then apparently, apparently she's starting to have a bad dream where like humanity just killed itself. And she's like, oh, but my sustenance, I need food.
But you don't know it's a dream at first. And I was like, what the hell kind of a take did this story do?
Yeah, that is true.
It was so weird.
Because if you start off, you're like, what? We had an apocalypse. She got herself a blood bank. And then she's freaking sucking the blood from this turtle. What's
the
turtle's name from? What's the turtle from Finding Nemo?
Oh,
we all know who you talked about.
Crush?
Yes. Poor Crush. Sucking the blood of Crush. And then she's sucking all the little blood. And then she just chooses freaking death, which I kind of liked. Shit, that's art. We're coming back. I mean,
well, no, the scene is kind of cool because it's like, granted, okay, due to pollution and everything else going on, but blah, 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 the sun can't come out, so therefore she can't die. I kind of like that concept. Like, she's ready for death, but so much has happened that it can't come.
Yeah, she's like in the Matrix. She was like, let me die. Where is the sun? Where's Ethan Van Sciver to shine upon her?
Half the people in this chat now looking at this page going, lucky girl.
Lucky girl, get out.
They got to finish the story.
Yeah, and then she wakes up and she's like, oh, in her coffin, in her pajamas.
Mm-hmm. Suspended she's from like, the ceiling.
Yeah, suspended from the ceiling, because why the heck not? And then she's flying all over the place. She finds...
Amanda's like, no sheets, 0 out of 10 for this book.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's the real issue I have with this book setup.
So she finds this allegedly Texan. The art. Let's talk about art. It's talking about art, trying to hold back. So she hypnotizes his bodyguard, the senator's bodyguard, to be a 9-year-old or 9-month-old. And then he eventually joins all the other 9-month-olds to watch a show, to watch an anime, to watch Paw Patrol, basically. and they have themselves a little conversation about how he's horrible, and he's like, whatever. Then she does the thing, and these are art. I'm trying to hold back art. There's things I like about the art. And then he gets eaten by the lions.
You should probably just talk about the art as we're going through it. No, you're not gonna want to go back through to find the
pages, I am taking notes, Amanda. I already got your page, the one that we all like.
Okay.
I have my little whiteboard here. I'm all sorts prepared and shit.
She's got those little like yarns that go from one picture to another.
Yep.
Okay.
And then we have my fellow Americans. We have a presidential speech about how there's a terrorist and just killing everybody in the oil industry, blah, blah, blah.
But it's supposedly affecting the world because nobody's buying oil, which is affecting everything. So he's like, don't be afraid if you're, you know, buying. Buying is okay.
Yeah, but look at some of these looks of like, I just don't give a shit. And then he gets narked. Narked on national television.
That came out of nowhere too, by the way.
This guy right here. This chick is doing a weird thing. He's like, oh, I'm going to give Kelsey credit for all these different expressions that he has. Go back.
Go back.
Go back. Like, this dude is super worried. I don't know what the... Oh, this dude's lifting. Okay.
He's so probably only worried because there's like, you know, they just did it. He might be worried he's going to be a daddy.
There it is. All right. So then, somehow, some way, the church gets involved.
Another weird, turn.
Well, I mean, it's vampires, so like, it's not out of pocket. So the church gets involved, and they find the biggest monk that they have. They're like, who is the biggest one you got? We want that one. And he was like, it is done. I'll take care of it. And she's just flying around as Man-Bat from Batman. She goes to her house. She's checking her email, seeing what's up. And then this gigantic man with a gigantic bibble says, good morning. You must be the lady of the house. Good morning. Let's see herself. I like how Vanessa told herself to go back. Shut up, Sister Ronan. And then we get super weird. So this guy.
Or lame.
Huh?
Nothing. Go ahead.
Did you say lame?
Lame.
Yeah.
Yep.
I didn't like especially these last two issues. I'm gonna spoil that right now. I didn't care for that at all.
So Matt says, I keep checking in every 10 minutes or so, and this book just gets more nuts. LOL. Mm-hmm. So we get a gigantic man just all up in her house trying to mansplain who he is. I'm just playing chat. He's like, hello, I'm Samuel. Samuel. It's because Samuel is not spelled correctly. Samuel. Somalia. Somalia. Damn, that's cold. Samuel says, you must be the new countess. And he has his gigantic book. And he's like, I wrote this book. And so she started to transform. He's literally bopping her in the head with the Bible.
Dude's trying to get her to crowdfund for him.
Yeah, he's like, buy my book.
He doesn't scream, so he's got to go door to door.
Yeah, going. He's like a Jehovah's Witness.
That's the proof copy. He's showing people that it exists. It is done. And he will print on, print and deliver. That's what's going on. Well, that's what it's come to in this crowdfunding.
That's what it's come to. We got an example of how crowdfunder works.
He ain't gonna leave anybody behind. He's even going to the crazy hoes stuff. He's gonna be like, hey, wanna buy a book?
Sister Rona says this whole section made no sense at all.
I agree.
Yes. So the church getting involved is not out of pocket for vampire stories, right? Like Van Helsing, whole bunch of, like, that's a common thing across, like, horror. is that like if you're going against vampires, sometimes there's a sect of the church that's like, no, their job is to hunt. Like they're on the books, but our books be deep because we're old. But we have this section of the church. Their job is to
hunt. Now that you say that, it makes sense. But the first time I'm reading it, I'm like, no, you have the environment, you have the government, you have the church. Those are the big key things that are jumping out at me.
Yeah. You forget she's a vampire. Yes. You have to remember this chick's a vampire. Or like, I can understand.
She's a terrorist.
Like, yeah, she's a terrorist vampire. We killed her freaking shark best friend. How? Like I said, she's fucking John Wick. She's John Wick. Instead of the dog, it's a shark. And instead of like money and the Baba Yaba, she has the Dank Fang. That she's trying to cure her Dank Fang, her gingivitis. She has a cavity. That's all she has.
Probably sounded better in the writer's head.
Yeah, he was like, yeah.
I had to wonder at times. It's before this, but there was like dick jokes, and I'm like,
oh yeah, there's this weird obsession with dicks.
I'm like, where did that come from? No, actually, it's coming up, isn't it? No, yeah, it's coming up because it takes another turn. Never mind.
Continue. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. The chat is... Sister Ronan, in particular, I see you. And then Omer Glitch says, ye power of Christ compels you! All right, so... He's like, I wrote this book, blah, blah, blah. And in my hands, it's the most powerful weapon in all creation. Let me show you Bop. And it was like, Washish, as a person who's hit another human being with a book, and not like that. Let me tell you something. My little brother didn't appreciate it at the time, but it ain't like that. Get lights. Crash, kush. Just knock out a vampire with a book. Going through multiple stories of a building. Like, okay. And then we have some blasphemy going on. Mm-hmm. And then, like, I don't know if this guy... So, I'm assuming he is an average height human male. This thing is gigantic. I'm not even sure if this thing
is
a person.
Alien! You gotta involve the aliens in this story now.
The thing is, he freaking has a cross. I'm like,
it's
is
like
he
the
just...
Vatican's got, like, ridiculous technology that we don't know about. Like, together.
Yeah, does he just have jaundice? Because he needs to go get some more vitamins?
I'm thinking it's aliens.
Or it's like, is this Lex Luthor? Oh, goodness. Sister Rhoda says, a vampire would not put solar panels on their damn house. How do you know that? What if she's just trying to get the tax credit, Sister Ronan?
Maybe more money.
That's a big ass house she has, and she has more money, more problems. She needs to get some solar panels.
I'm assuming everything she made on that website was reported to the IRS. So
yeah, like she needs to get some tax credits. And obviously she has a gigantic battery bank, and we're not going to talk about how that affects the environment. Let's move on. So we get Sir Egghead, and they're talking, and then now she's hung up. And then they're having a whole bunch of exposition about he is Samael, the angel of death. And then this is his daddy. And I'm like, this is the part.
It's like a Voltron bad guy or something.
Hold on. What?
Did some digging.
Where is the funky? Like the crazy looking. Like he could have went like super crazy with that.
Oh, like, the writer probably steered him somewhere else.
Yeah, he's probably like, just make it like a kind of demon-y, put eyes and like angel-y. I was like, man, you could have had him looking freaking crazy. Not that one. Where's the one where it's like a whole bunch of circles? Here we go. No.
You're looking for like the hoop one.
Yeah, the hoop one. So this one has multiple heads. This one has six wings. This one is just bright. Here we go. The hoop one. But like the hoop one's my daddy. Like how did you become
Seraphim,
this big
yeah.
this big muscular man. I was like, well, I get it from my dad. He's like really big. There's some good genetics. How about your mom? My mom's okay. She's okay. You know, she ran track in high school.
No, no. She's the beautifulest human.
She's beautifulest human. She ran track in high school. You know, she did the long jump. She was very fit.
Worked at a Dunkin' Donuts.
Yeah, she was a... She worked at... She got a D1 college offer, but, you know, she had me. Michael Dietsche, the book was foreshadowed by the books on the sunken ship. Sheesh, there's no pleasing you people. Of course not. Why would we want to be pleased by reading comics?
I don't get it. Is. Books in one spot and books in another mean foreshadowing? Wasn't she just meaning that she educated herself with the books that she found in the deep of the ocean? That's all I took from it.
What if there's this Sherlock Holmes in the ocean? Like, that's not going to help her against this man of God with this Gigantor book? With this gigantic artist edition book? It's hardcover! Chat, I have an artist edition book. It's hardcover. It's handmade. Oh my goodness, we're going to make this sound like a Rocaforce thing. It's on Etsy. It's handmade. It's hand cut with my hands, hand stapled. There's only, how many of those? Oh, there's only a 100. 100 in the first printing.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about Groken. The minis. Groken 1 minis.
Oh, okay. Is that what he said?
That's what it was. That's what we knew was, Groken was like, actually coming. With my own hands. Yeah, he did a... Yeah. Put it in, put first the commerce trademark on Groken.
Oh, wow.
So he did a thing on Etsy. They went in the mail and he's like, trademark, checkmate. First to commerce. I was like, get it, dad. Oh, my goodness. All right. So he's talking all the words about how he's going to eliminate her evil from the world, blah, 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 blah. And he has all these eyes in this gigantic book. And then he took her eye, just, you know, sure, why not?
Because, yoink, that's mine.
Yeah, she's like, boink, no eye for you. And then he's like, I need to take my clothes off.
Yeah, look, I was so like, what are you?
There you go, man. Doing? I should have said, Amanda, dang it.
What did he say? So he's like, yeah, first, your body must be made ready.
Dang, it's hot in here.
Do not be alarmed, Countess. I would never ravage one so base as you. My garments are sacred, and I do not wish to soil them when I deliver you.
Yeah, but it's
like, first, your body must be made ready. I'm like, what kind of a book? What kind of a book?
Like, what is this? So he had to take his old Navy t-shirt and jeans off.
$120 jeans. Like,
I know, right? With his black briefs. Hopefully those are swim trunks, so it keeps all his package together. Swole is a mother. I don't understand why though. Like, Kelsey, why he gotta be so swole?
Because it's comics.
It's comics. We're gonna make him gigantic. And then he's starting just the right words. That one kind of says, Mom. I don't know what he's trying to do. He's sweating because he, you know, this part kind of reminds me, for the ones of you who went to university in the past, I don't know, 15 years with drop boxes and you have until 11:59 p.m. to turn your assignment in. Man, there was a lot of times at 11:45, I was like, I need to finish this paper. Oh, my God. I need to submit it. Dropbox. So then, like, so this is
bag of dicks joke.
Bags of dick jokes.
Over and over.
Yeah, I don't know what the writer was thinking. Like, oh yeah, this is gonna be good. This will be funny. It's already we have Zod sweating over here. Like, we don't need all of this. Then he's writing whatever, and her
book, Slavic one.
Yep. We have to show her Dank Fang one more time. Oh, and this is the word where she's like, oh, humanity, it's killing itself and blah, trying to save it. And he's like, you're not going to save it. He was like, "Where? You only did one. Like, there's a whole industry. Like, come on now. Then he finishes his haiku on her. And he's about to, like, kill her. with a sword, just randomly a sword. Then all of a sudden,
knock, knock, knock on the door.
Knock, knock, knock. Her other friends that she didn't talk about, her jellyfish dress. Been talking about this damn shark this whole time. I didn't know you bonded with the damn dress too. So this man of war jellyfish just comes out of nowhere and freaking chokes him.
Puts him on, wears him.
Yeah. And then she sucks his blood because she's a vampire. Her homie Toby is in a bucket. Head is in a bucket. Because he treated him like a voodoo doll. This is the first time her name gets said, Vala. And then
the aliens come.
No, so
Plan B.
First we have the U.S.
Navy
firing with the rail gun. And she's still alive with her one eye. She needs to get an eye patch. And then we have knockoff Lex Luthor.
Father, Megamind.
Father Megamind. Oh, they're raining holy water. She's raining holy water, and now she's hiding under his Bible, and she's trying to get her homie. First, her jellyfish dies. Her man of war jellyfish dies. Mm-hmm. And then she's like, bastards! And then the biggest the thing that probably, if Stato wasn't already out of the story, he was out at this point.
This is like, what?
What is this?
I was like, what is that? I don't know.
It is the biggest freaking this is not a licensed aircraft over Count Chocula's.
It's the Vatican's helicarrier.
Yes. Raining down holy water on a vampire. And Dang is actually in this story. Hold on, because we need to bring Dang Fang in. Dang. So she's having a Dang Fang moment. And she's trying to get her boy Toby, but he disintegrates.
And he's then, like, don't worry about me. Worry about yourself.
And then Archbishop Mastermind Luther.
See, that's a simp.
Dang.
He's sitting there like cooking and he's like, no. No, you just...
You're my friend. You gave me purpose.
Thing. It's okay.
I was just playing COD by myself. And then you showed me the way.
It's not a helicarrier. It's a holy carrier. I agree.
It is a holy carrier. And then she tries to simp her simps, but she only has one more bar. And she's already on red. If she was on Apple, she should put it on low power mode. She probably would have got the message out.
She wanted to tell them to all be activists. Oh my gosh, I rolled my eyes so hard I got a headache.
Put the earth first. Do good from henceforth.
Yes.
She says with blood all over her face.
Yeah, do good, guys, as I got Aemon Targaryen in this story. I got one eye left.
Bleeding. Isn't that ridiculously apt though? Like with some of those activists where they're like, you know. Do good, be kind, be accepting as they're trying to ruin someone's life and they got like
yep.
And cheering then on their enemies down.
She starts talking to the book, and because we only saw her said her name like two times, my name is Vala. What do I call you? I call you my big book of tricks.
Do you know what her last name is?
No.
Dacian.
Huh? Dang, that hit me. That hit hard. Validation is here. She gets her big book, and apparently they're having her and the book are having a conversation because I didn't know the book was a living freaking thing. So her house gets exploded. I'm sure, you know, maybe this is what happened, Bird. She said, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. And then, like, there it is.
Yep. Jake got her out.
Yep, so she said, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
He said, we don't cover vampires.
Yeah. And then somehow, some way, they're talking about dicks again. And they're mm-hmm. like, oh yeah, the terrorist got, blah, 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 blah. But then, this bitch ends up on the moon. What?
Yep.
And then there was never another issue again. What?
Issue 6, July 2018. I may try to find issue 6 just be like,
I don't think it came out.
Oh my goodness. So that was the story with the chat. Okay, art. Sister Roa said earlier it's called tooth decay. Mm-hmm. It could have been worse. There wasn't bits of fruit in it, talking about the Jell-O. This whole section didn't make sense at all, which is the rest of the story.
Yeah, it got just turn after turn as to what? Where did that come from?
Yep. Ellie says, V doing a product placement spots for State Farm. Sister Runa says it would make a great Bollywood movie.
You missed the Stugal earlier. It wasn't too far ago.
I'll go up. And then revive Dank Fang. So he said Stugal said something. Let's see.
Not too far before.
Okay. It's not a good story, but damn, if it wasn't entertaining.
You know, the setup was really good and the premise wasn't terrible. It's just after two, all the rails went off and it kind of, it's like those streaming shows where you're like, they give you the first couple episodes and everybody loves them and they're awesome. And then, you know, the stuff that you don't like seeps in after that once they think they've got you. That's kind of what I feel like this series did.
Oh my, it was a quick read, though. Like, yeah, I remember we were talking about it. I'm like, I didn't feel like I was bogged down reading it. It went pretty quick, but there were many WTF moments.
I had a good time looking at Kelsey's art. I mean,
well, we're about to talk to art. Let's go.
Okay.
It's not a helicarrier. It's a holy carrier. Mm-hmm. Let's see here. That dude is all K levels. Dang. All right. So Michael DJ says the funniest part for me is imagining Kelsey slumped over his desk drawing this shit for whiskey money. I hope he got more than whiskey money. No one draws a package like Kelsey. That's right. I think they're all talking about the swole guy. That's a Kelsey self-insert. I mean, that's how I would insert myself. Like, no, not an accurate picture. The best version of me that could exist.
Of a man?
Of him.
Oh, okay.
That's what they're saying. Kelsey self-insert. Bungee smugglers, yep.
Somebody could actually do a book called Dank Fang because this here is Dark Fang. So
yes. No. You know, same. We can still do Dank Fang. I, for one, congratulate Stat for his refined taste in water vampire comics. Yep.
tripped right into that one for sure.
Yep. This is different from my usual day, Austin. The Jane Austen book club reading. I mean, the usual. Not my usual. Oh, my goodness. So, yeah. So, that is the story. It was stupid. Like what Stat said, I think somebody could work with this premise and actually come up with something. But I don't know if this was just the writer trying to get his IP out there or what the motivation was. Quite frankly, I don't care enough.
He's
going to
trick him into learning something by the end.
Yes. I don't know what to say. That jellyfish was so dumb. I can't even. Yeah, that was a random thing. I was like, this whole time has been about the shark. You never mentioned jellyfish dress.
I like how it's walking around in a trench coat. Like,
yeah. How in the... She got stuff on her legs, still have booty shorts, her shirt, hair over the eye. I mean, for a composition and a gigantic book. And he actually, this is a photo of some sort. This is like a photo overlay. Mm-hmm. Sister Rose says we're all activists now, chat. weren't we fighting against that? Weren't we like, oh yeah, comics. All right, so let's go. Let's go. Let's go transition to the part we want to talk about. Well, we have story critiques, and I think we kind of covered it. Like, this book was kind of dumb.
Yeah, after two, I mean, it seemed like he started to just try to use, like, I'm criticizing the environmental stuff. Now I'm going to criticize the church. Now I'm going to criticize the government. And then it just got away from him.
Yeah.
Got a little bit big.
So, yeah, it got, because, I mean, probably with 20 issues, he could have, the writer could have done something with that.
Yeah. One institution at a time.
Yeah, because it was like, it did kind of feel like that, but like now he's going after capitalists. Now it's the government. Now it's the church.
Yeah, it wasn't, I mean, yeah, that first issue was, I mean, there was some interesting stuff in there. It's a nice setup. And then after she destroyed the entire oil platform as a single shark, I think it literally jumped the shark.
Baby shark, baby shark,
it started to lose me. And then by that third, fourth issue, I was pretty much just like, all right, I'm going to finish this. Yeah, I'm going to take my lumps in the chat.
It's your fault, Bird. It's all my fault. Right. It's all your fault. All right. So the
art. Love the art, though.
The art. So let me full pick. There it is. So this is the first panel where I was like, okay, Kelsey, I see you. I see what you did here. So you have her on the ceiling, and then you have her face, but then you kind of have a face here again. And then the boat as the eye. I was like, okay, I like this layout, Kelsey.
That was very pretty.
I really like that one. I think with Kelsey having this like animated style that was throughout this book, like there were times where like, I don't know, like one of the things that we learned since all of us have been in Comicsgate for a while is that these turnarounds for these floppies on the artist were ridiculous. Mm-hmm. So there's a lot of things that they did for time saving purposes to meet deadline, right? So yeah. I don't know. And you could kind of see in like backgrounds and stuff like that. And I'm not going to say, oh no, it was bad. But there's some parts of the book where like he kind of showed out a little bit. And I think this one, maybe not show out, that's a little strong, but he kind of like, hey, I kind of know what I'm doing here with this layout, which I enjoyed. So another one that I liked. And Amanda, if you have any ones, just let me know. Let's go 50.
Nothing specific. This one really struck me, though.
Yeah, I really like this one. 56. No, don't do this to me. Show me not the guided view. Shit! Okay, I'm right here.
One downhill.
So I definitely like the use of color. So it's basically all purple, right? Pink and purple.
Yep.
But he uses different shades and he uses shading. So like at no time was I like, oh my God, I can't see. Like you could definitely differentiate each thing and what it's supposed to be, right?
Yep.
And even like this, like her dying, you're still like in the high lavenders. And I really liked this, these two pages. All right, and then we'll go to 62, which I believe is this way. Give me, okay. 62. I missed it by one. Okay, so this panel right here. Let me, thank you. So this panel right here. So at first I was like, I don't like this, right? So basically what he's doing, to use like photographer language, is that he's overexposing the background and kind of underexposing the foreground.
Mm-hmm. To create depth.
Yeah, to create depth and create like I'm coming from the outside in kind of scenario. And at first, I'll admit, at first I didn't like this panel. I was like, what? I was like, but then the more I looked at it, I was like, okay, I see what you're doing here. Right. So this is in the same realm as I would say with like Kenneth with Grokken, is that Kelsey really understands color theory. So even though this is all supposed to read, except for this is supposed to read a window, right? This is all supposed to read white. But it's not white. Does that make sense, Bird?
Yeah.
Okay. Just making sure. So like there's gold, like gold, but it's not like obnoxious. But yeah, it's a, for lack of better phrase, it's a good trick. Like my mind right. read that this is all white, but it's not. Like looking at it, it's not white. But then we have these lions, and we have her, and we have him and this guy who's pulling out like what is that, a Tech Nine? I think
yeah.
bodyguards like carry Tech Nines. Go back. Am I pressing the wrong? There it is. Oh no, go back. Oh no, I'm lost. So yeah, even so, I mean, I liked particular that panel. Then we go to 68. I already told you I like this. I like this grid. I mean, I don't know if this is like a homage to, because no, did this happen before Velocity or after?
I'm not sure.
All right. So, I mean, it's an interesting layout. He did it, you know, because he could have made these just little pop-ups and then this as one panel and we would have been good.
Mm-hmm.
But I think doing the grid across the whole thing, it kind of gives a uniformity. Amanda, is this page on a page turn?
I believe it is.
Okay. So, like, you see this page and then you turn it and it's this?
Yep, it is.
Okay. So, I mean, that's a great use of a page turn. Something you lose.
Oh, wait. How you're seeing it is exactly how it is in the book.
Okay. It would have been better as a page turn to be like, circle, no, turn off. And then you turn the page and it's this shit.
Yeah, no, it's set up like that.
Well, I mean, it may have been in the floppy because do you have ads in the collected?
No. I do not.
And not well. Too. Yeah. So there's, it's possible in the floppy that was a page turn and that would have been a great like storytelling tool. But I really like that.
Before layout. You go on, Ellie is asking if vampires explode heads now. A little bit later, it shows that she's gone through the, what do you want to call it? The metal detectors, and she went into the building. So supposedly she is there in person, but nobody remembers her being there.
Yeah,
that's only like a brief mention.
She's cutting off heads, though. That's what she's doing. Probably with her long freaking fingernails. And with Jake from State Farm. All right, and I think the last one I want to talk about is, okay, so we already talked about that, like, Kelsey could have got real weird with this, like, oh, this is my dad. He didn't have to look like that. He could have been the ring within rings and be like, what? And we already, and the thing is, at this point in
story, yeah, but the ring within rings, how can the dad be having an arm just like the son is? It's kind of like mimicking the pose. Can't do that with a ring.
Eh. I mean, we're ready. You just add arms to the rings. Okay. Because my point is, we're already in weirdness. Like, the story got real weird.
Why not a ring for a dad? Right.
Yeah, why not? Just go, like, get something that's, like, biblically correct and scary looking.
Yeah.
Like, oh, yeah, that thing. With his 150-pound bibble. All right, so let's go look at what people have said about art. So earlier, when I had to ignore you guys because you start talking about art. So Sister Rhoda said, the art is okay. It doesn't look great blown up. It looks all right. For comics, it's fine for cartoons. Well, I mean, people like different things. I'm usually not into the cartoon style either, but the coloring fixes it on this. Yeah, I mean, that is true. And then Carbon Heart also says the art is not. It's nice. It's noise. The art is noise, yes. Omar Glitch says, it's good art considering he was doing three people's job, penciler, inker, and colorist. I wish there was a little bit more rendering, but that would have taken him a lot longer. There it is. I mean, he was doing the work of three people. And you probably know he wasn't getting the page rate of three.
Yeah, he kind of already always is, though, it seems like. Well, right now he's just doing coloring for a couple of books, so.
Yeah. What is this? Hi, Kelsey. One world.
If Hellboy, she's talking about me.
Okay, Hellboy says, has Kelsey been streaming lately or what, MIA? He's kind of MIA because
he's working.
Working, yeah. But, I mean, that's not the first time. Omer Glitch says, that's not a Tech Nine. It's an Uzi. Similar, though. I mean, like, come on now. It's color. It's ink on paper. All right, let's go see. Omer Glitch says, the colors do a lot of lifting in this art. There's almost no liner art. There's almost no line art rendering in this whole thing. That is true. I mean, that's where's his swoness, his self-insert. I mean, this panel. Let me do it, Kindle. God damn it. I mean, this whole panel, like, I mean, he probably kept the pencilings and just used the coloring, right? So he probably inked over the outline and, like, what he needed to ink over. And then these were probably his pencils that he just used in coloring. And I'm going to need to get out of this mode because it's gonna zoom in on his bungee smuggler. There it is. See anybody else say anything about art? I don't even know what to say. That okay, we got that. Jellyfish was dumb. Kelsey's going to be on what in the shit? Dojo.
Yeah, well, they gotta promote the Nexus Scourge. So
yeah, Dojo. This is a really borderline, but I'm feeling in a good mood because we're gonna be on hiatus. We finally found Angela Mann, Mr. Bungely Smuggler. And then Cicero says that's Kelsey looking in the mirror. Yep. Let's see here. Last but not least, well, Amanda Stat, do you have anything to say about the art? Because
no, I think we covered a lot of it.
Yep, mm-hmm. We looked at a lot of it too since we went page by page. Which
was cool. I like most of the art in here. It's just the writing that I personally just
wasn't the story. Like no rock on the artist. It's the writer I have issues with.
it's kind of true. I mean, like if you were to take all the words away, it's maybe improved. I hate being that guy, but you know, it seems to be a trend in the books that we look at where it's, you know, the art's usually pretty darn good and the writing is the ultimates and this and I don't remember all of the I remember the Cable. I think the problem I had with the writing was just that you really needed to know a lot about X-Men and stuff to kind of get it and understand it. Otherwise, it just seems like, whoa, who is this? What is this? And they didn't really explain it. But I mean, like this is not really much different. You have the stuff that chased most of us away from mainstream comics or even like semi-mainstream comics like Image Dark Horse. And, you know, the art still looks pretty good, but it's, you know, that's half the equation. So when you're reading the book and it's kind of a turnoff, that doesn't really help. So.
Omer Glitch says Kelsey drew Anna a lot in this. Did he even know Anna when he drew this?
I don't think
this?
He knew her at that time.
Yeah, I don't think he knew her either. Yeah, so, but I mean, a lot of times we're picking the book club based off an artist because we're trying to get familiar with CG's
2018. Past. So this is like just before he came in. Maybe this is what pushed him towards CG.
Well, I mean, you figure he had to have this done before it published.
Right.
So he probably at least had a couple issues under his belt in 2017.
Or at least the trade came out 2018. So maybe it was 2017. Mm-hmm. But that's what it's giving me on the little page at the beginning of the book.
The little page at the beginning of the book.
Page. Info page, yeah.
All right. So Ellie says Nexus looks dope as AF. Dojo says, are you saying that was a shill? I said nothing about my book. Fair enough. Alrighty, so the last thing. Would you recommend this title? Amanda, go first. Amanda is dead. She is dead.
She quit.
She was like, I can't take this shit anymore. Can't believe me.
I'll take that as a no.
Sorry, I had my mouth full.
Oh, she's
like, I was eating the book. She was like, I never want to see this thing again.
No,
I was eating a churro. I don't know. It could be interesting to some. I would probably definitely preface it with, or preface it, however you want to pronounce it, that it's a weird out there book, but it was by no means heavy, like hard to read. It was just a weird trip. Like, you probably want to be on drugs because it'll enhance what you're watching.
That's a heck. That's a pull quote. You want to be on drugs when you read this.
You want to be on drugs when you read this.
Right.
So what level of drug are you thinking? Like, are we thinking about like legal drugs? Like, you want to be drunk, or in your state, if your state allows it, you want to be on 420, or are we going to the street
side
pharmaceuticalist?
A little rougher.
So street side pharmaceuticalist.
Yeah.
All right, so I mean, I would not recommend it unless somebody was like, I'm a Kelsey Shannon fan and I want to read everything that he was involved with. And I'm like,
only when it's mentioned that you want to read everything will you include this in Kelsey
Shannon's work. Or, okay, maybe not read. I want to have all of Kelsey Shannon's art in my possession. And I'm like, then you need to get, and I'll even call it Dank Fang. And I guess I would have to preface it like it's really called Dark Fang Volume 1, Earth Rising. But on the streets, we call it Dank Fang. Dank Fang. Bird. This is your time to defend yourself because it is you.
Okay, so, you know, if you're looking at objectively, if you are more of the, I suppose we say progressive persuasion, I would say yeah. It's got a lot of that kind of thing in there that would make people go like, yeah, buddy, this is a vampire story for me that I can sink my teeth into. But if the progressive type stuff and the DEI type stuff and whatnot has sort of pulled you away from comics and different, you know, as far as the writing goes. And obviously the art itself, like, there are going to be people that don't like that very cartoony type stuff. They like a little more rendering, you know, like the Jim Lee fans, the Rob Liefeld fans. This might not quite work for it. It really depends if you're into like the progressive stuff. If so, yeah, absolutely. If not, no, absolutely not. You know, so it's either a love or hate, I think, situation.
Vaughn Suga says the reaction. Yeah, I'm surprised. I did, Bird. You did it to me. This is all your fault.
What'd I do?
It's Dank Fang.
Dank Fang.
It was all
me?
You.
It was all me. They voted on it.
Let this be a lesson of just blind fandom.
Mm-hmm. It's
just
true.
Give yourself a second to read the description.
It's absolutely true.
All right. So Vaughn Suga says reaction. Yep. The reaction to this book is what pushed Kelsey over to us. Like, whose reaction? Maybe his. When he looked at it, but like, this is shit. Jav is just three dots. Snuggy says, we're back to this page, I see.
Well, if they go to the page two, I'm going to get yelled at. So we got to put this one in here.
Okay. Michael DJ says, LOL. Omar Glitch says, crack. Ellie says, ruffa? Yeah, ruffa. Ruffa. Ronan says, I don't think any amount of drugs could save this book.
Oh.
DJ says, I kind of want to know what she does on the moon. I'm going to admit something. I was kind of wondering what the... I'm like, this bitch is on the moon?
He goes up there and the aliens have a giant oil rig on it.
I know. And she's like, I got to get these aliens.
So she turns into a shark and floats away.
These jaundiced aliens on the moon. Well, she's definitely going to go hungry because there's no people on the moon. So she needs to get back to Earth. To Earth to eat.
Well, that last picture looked like she had a bunch of like tech stuff on her. Like, you know, like she was like, looked like a Alita Battle Angel or something
what,
like that.
This one?
Yeah. Look at like her shoulders and it's like a weird helmet.
Oh, helmet thingy. Yeah. Yeah. What if she just takes a nap and then she like eats the astronauts?
Yeah.
Maybe that Beastman says he likes the Hanna-Barbera look. Fair enough. Mm-hmm. Sister Mona says it's shit.
He really had a hard time with it.
I don't know. He was really mad at you.
It's I'm just fault. Waiting for like unsubscribe to my channel and just I'm an enemy for life.
Yep. Jav says, I wouldn't even go there. That book was all over the place. The three dots were for the mouthful. Okay.
The mouthful.
The people who read it and hated it. LOL. The people who read it and hated it. You mean us? It was people like us that where we're like, what the shit?
I guess how it's too heck, heady for us.
How in the heck did the Vatican get this gigantic?
This is highbrow stuff.
Yeah, and he has there's people playing horns. I guess that's supposed to be Zeus. There's a whole bunch of stuff going on. Propellers, raining down holy water. There's a lot.
Raining down what?
Holy water.
Holy water.
Holy water. Well, I mean, honestly, like, if you were even a little bit Christian, like, this book could offend you a lot.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, a lot.
Yeah, these last two issues were tough to get
through. All right. It only got good when she gets to the moon because it was over. You were like, it's the last page. It's over. Jav says, I'm a fan of Evangelicon, and considering the last two episodes, the Human Instrumentality Project canon, and Dank Fang, was too weird for me. I'm a fan of Evangelicon, and consider the last two episodes canon. And Dank, oh, dang. That's a deep cut. That's the weebs understood what you just said. So Michael DJ says next up, Stat draws Vala on his draw stream.
Not a chance.
Prompts are coming back, people. Prompts are coming back.
Oh, boy.
Monstu says, incredible, incredible. That's the Vatican copper. Vatican copter.
Copter.
And then Omer Glitch.
The helicopter.
Says, yeah. The Vatican.
Copter.
Copter. And then Omer Glitch says, holy water? Yes, water. As it's said in New Jersey. I blame my time in Jersey for me saying water. It's
you
not
say
as
it
strong
like George
as
says it. George, not Jersey, but similar.
What? Water?
Yeah. I always chuckle when he says water.
Yeah, I have to force myself
water,
to rooter, say water.
Rooter, water.
Yeah, it was water. Yeah, it's W-O-D-D-E-R, water. Sister Rose says, this review was actually fun. Maybe we should do more ship books.
Am I going to get credit for that? No, that's going to go to Amanda and Vanessa.
How dare
over
you,
here
sir.
In the corner.
Yeah.
Collective huddle, memory there.
Huddle in the corner. All right, so that ends Dank Fang. I do also blame the chat because they did vote it on it, but it was your fault. It was your fault, Bird. You were like, Dank Fang. And I was like,
Dank Fang. Yeah. Yeah. That's...
Even I didn't read the description before I started typing it. I was like, oh, yeah, Kelsey Shannon. Dark Fang, Volume 1.
I'll take the credit. That was at least they got a memorable episode out of it.
Alrighty. Now we have things to do. We have poles to drop on. I have poles to jump on.
Drop it like it's hot, Vanessa.
I have
drop
to
it like this book.
Before I do that, I'm older. It hurts now, the move. Oh, my goodness. Aging is real. All right. So we have to do polls. What?
Fun, Stugal.
I won't even.
Yes, 100% Stat JW. Yeah, it's Stat JW's fault.
Of course, a Stat Justice Warrior kind of still works. I'm not there for justice.
You're there for justice.
Not social justice. My justice.
All right, so we have two book clubs to do and a sandwich and two sandwich Saturdays. I'm on all these damn polls today. I didn't stretch my hips.
There's a Dank Fang 2 for you guys.
I know, Dank Fang 2, Electric Boogaloo. Dank Fang 2, to the moon!
Dank Fang too soon.
All right, so we got the chat reads. So we're doing both of our book clubs. So we're going to start with the chat reads.
Now, this one is...
That is... Those are... Right? No. The Hillbilly Book Club is the mainstream. So the chat reads is that we read a crowdfunding book, preferably from Comicsgate, but with all this shit going on, worse, you know, if it gets voted for, it gets voted for. Mm-hmm. So the rules are is that this project has to be readily available for people who want to participate and get the book. It also can't be monetarily prohibited. So if you're like, oh, let's read this, but it's on $100 on eBay, we ain't doing this. So readily available, reasonably priced. And let me know when you guys got nominations in the chat. They're talking about Evangelicon. So Amanda, do you have any
did the majority of us get Ghosts by Matakumbe Key?
I did not, but that doesn't mean you can't put it out there.
I know what Sato did and Stippling did, right, Sato?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
As long as it's still readily available, is that on his website?
Not yet. Once he's done fulfilling it, will be, I believe.
Okay.
Oh, so it's not available on Indiegogo anymore?
I think so.
I think he did shut that off, right? Yeah, okay.
Okay.
Don't worry about that one then.
All right.
It'll take a bit to get there.
Well, it's gonna, because what? We'll have April off. So May?
3 months, right? Want to be 3 months?
No, mm-hmm. this is going to be two. In May.
Yeah, okay.
And then the next one will be in June. So April will be off for book club stuff.
We haven't done Grokin 2?
I mean, didn't we kind of, though?
Okay.
You put Cordrath in there. I think quite a few people grab that.
Is that what the shit? Okay.
Wait, I'm not sure if he's got that available for those that don't have it yet. So
Omer Glitch, is this a real one? Is it really $5? What the shit? Hold on.
He runs sales on that, on some of those introductory early ones. I can't tell whether it's to get more readers or to liquidate stock, mm-hmm. really. But I mean,
probably.
I don't know what his print run was, but.
A lot, probably.
Comics to the left. There you go.
Give it to me. I saw him. 20 bones. That ain't the worst.
I know he had a temporary sale at some point.
Okay, so once again, RGB Blade Devil, $5. What's his web? It's Jav, are you... You're about to become a mod. Hold on. Can I do this in here?
He was the last one. Congratulations on holding out that long.
Hold on. I need to pull you here. So, Jav.
You can drop that link.
If you could drop that link, you should have a wrench now. If you could drop that link so I could just see what it is. What it is.
I've seen Blade Devil around because isn't he either funding to or just ended to or isn't he on something?
Okay, so Omer Glitch says, if it hasn't been done, let's do it. It's shit though. Sure. So Omer Glitch says, we do July, Eric July. Nice. Number one. It's on there now.
Have you backed that one, right, Vanessa?
Yeah, I have that one.
I don't think Stippling, and I don't think you have Stato, and I have not.
Well, I let it get to vote.
It's fine. It's fine to vote, and I suppose if we vote on it, I buy it, but... let's see what else.
Yeah, what else? Here we go. Let's go see. Let me go pull that up. On screen 3... which today is played by my iPhone in demand. Only $10.
How about Narwhal's got a bunch of books that are available, right?
Is this shipping right away?
Let me see here.
I think he said next day shipping earlier when he mentioned it.
Okay. Yeah, because there are number
I think Narwhal goes through eBay.
Yeah. So
maybe so I'll find Narwhal. So we're going to say RG3.
Amanda was quite taken with Cerberus. Maybe I'll,
I did
I'll
like ask, Cerberus.
Maybe yeah, I'll ask for that one. Cerberus. Yeah.
All
maybe
right.
a joint nomination.
Well, are you looking for what's his face's stuff right now?
Oh, Narwhal?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking right at it.
All right. So
he's got a bunch of different books to look at, if, and they're not horrible price for what he puts
what's,
into it.
What's his thing in eBay?
It's slash str slash Narwhal Comics. So he's got his link directly in his X profile.
Okay. Oh, look, I found it. I just had to put Narwhal Comics into the search bar.
It ain't chilling. Vanessa asked for the links. We're trying to figure out the next chat reads book.
Yeah. So you want to do Cerberus?
I think so. I think Amanda's, you know, like she really liked
I
that
really,
one,
I did really like that book.
Make for a good talk.
Right. So it's $23 on eBay.
Mm-hmm. What? I paid more.
Oh, snap.
Oh, no.
Now she hates it.
I know. For $4.87 shipping.
To the digital too. I don't know. Maybe not. It might have expired.
Oh, he has. All
well, it's
his
23,
shit
but then it's $4.87 shipping, so it's a little over 25 with shipping.
Okay, so there it is. See what's going on. Is Mel B still maintaining CG now?
I haven't had an update recently, and I was wondering that myself, exactly how up-to-date CG Now is.
Yeah. Jim's trying to shame us, where I'm like, hey, I just want to see. Yeah, that's an old book. Took 8 hours to track it down, fast as ever. Omar Glitch says Cyberfrog 2, Wreck Planet. Doesn't hurt my feelings.
Got that on eBay, right?
Yeah, he's got that on his store, I think. Let me have a look.
Technically, it's Cyberfrog Wrecked Planet. Okay.
Just don't get the executive.
Yeah, just get the regular. At least you didn't pay $100 for Ice on 2 cover. Did you pay $100 for Ice on 2 cover?
You probably love the Shane.
You
one.
Love Shane Davis that much? You pay $100?
Yeah, Wreck Planet's on there.
So this is not readily available, unfortunately.
Not yet.
Well, I mean, not Storm. Yet. Not ever. What are you talking about?
Oh, that's true. Because yeah,
he's not readily available. Angela was like, oh, I did not. All right, so does anybody else want to add? I'll give chat. I'm going to give you a minute to catch up with what I'm saying, but if anybody wants to nominate something. There we go. So,
all right, let me see.
So Max San Diego is here. Welcome to the chat. He says, hey, question. You guys talk to Roquefort. I'm trying to catch up with Grokin. I just need issues 1, 2, and 3, however his campaign doesn't have add-ons. Do you guys know how to get issue 2? So Kenneth doesn't, he likes to keep his campaigns as simple as possible. So he doesn't do add-ons. So unfortunately you're going to have to get a tier that has issue 2 and issue 3 on it. Which means you'll so he has an issue 1, 2, and 3. I think it's for $75 for all three books. Yeah. I mean, maybe you want to contact him via X, going to give it to you, also known as Twitter. Because I don't know if he's able to do like a sale. Like, I don't know how many copies he has. I know there's some copies. There were some copies on eBay. Let me see. So, broken.
There's also lost pages you could do too. They're readily available.
Hold on. Let me go answer this broken question real quick. So there's a Grokin 2 for $23. So what had happened and he mentioned it during this show when fulfillment started, is that a box of his books got stolen. So if you get a copy of Grokin and it's not signed on the inside with blue ink, you unfortunately got a stolen copy. So I'm not saying, actually, I'm kind of saying that this seller on eBay probably has some hot merchandise, allegedly, because I can't prove it. But there is a copy of Grokin 2 being sold, $23.
Sure.
And I don't see any other copies of Grokin floating around. No, this is all like, let me see if I put Kenneth's name, what I get. Because I'd rather you not buy from a unreputable human being. Let's see. It's a whole bunch of Superman, Bloodshot, Velocity. Some Batman. Vince Ron, 1 through 12. Kenneth, I love you, but no thank you. No thank you. Oh, shit. Let's see here. Yeah, I'm not seeing any. Yeah, it's probably from a CG or $55 for Inglourious Rex 1, Kenneth cover. Now I'm just shopping for Kenneth stuff. Vanessa, are you even looking for Grokin 2? I is, but I'm also, my eyes are seeing Kenneth stuff. It's by Kenneth. I already got that. Yeah, it looks like it's only the unreputable. Well, allegedly, because I didn't buy from that person. But like I said, if it's not signed in the inside cover with a blue marker, that product is stole. It's stolen. But yeah, so Max, go ahead and maybe reach out to him on Twitter to see if he has like a, you know, if he has leftover print. Because I don't know what his personal stock is and if he's willing to sell one. He's very accommodating like that, if he can be. Cicero says, my eyes have seen the glory of Kenneth Roquefort. Well, technically, my eyes haven't seen. I've seen his art. All right. So Omar Glitch is just going off the chains. We could do Lopez's.
How about the Mythicals? Hojo.
Hold on. Let me get. So this is, what the heck is that book's name? That I got. I haven't read yet. Not Garbage Man.
Garbage Man?
Alien Elmo?
No, the other one. Lopresti.
Oh, Lopresti. You're talking about
The Wraith.
Bloodhunters?
Yeah.
You already did The Wraith.
Not Bloodhunters. This is The Wraith number one. This is The Wraith number two.
Okay.
Yeah, this is getting to talk about Kit Carter and the like.
All right. So who did you say? You said Hojo?
Yeah, Mythicals number one. It's still available on Fund My Comic. It's the first one. Hardcover is $13 plus shipping.
Is that shipping like now?
Yeah, because he's funding too.
Okay. Cool. Maybe Kenneth will give me an original art page from Grokin for my birthday. Good luck with that. Become a Kenneth's witness today. Did Inglourious Rex 1 get reviewed already? I think. Did we do that? I think so.
I remember talking about it, but I don't know if it was the chat reads.
We may have to check the tape on that one. All right. Does anybody need to? I think we're good with this selection. Does anybody need another one? Jim Cox says, I'll hold my breath. Snuggy says, please do. Snuggless Kodrick McHuggison the second. What in the shit? You cannot encourage the chat to not breathe. How dare thee?
Dora Saga is a good suggestion, but I don't know that they're still.
I don't think it's only digital available. Unless they took the site down, which I don't know if they did or not, but last I saw on the site, it was only digitally sold.
So
although that's still an option. So I would think that would still qualify if we wanted to.
Let me have a look.
What was their thing called again?
Allegiance Art.
Okay.
Date of birth.
They're like you are struggling with spelling. Okay. Go to campaign. I don't store. Because I'm going to be honest, if it's physical, I wouldn't trust it, as far as this website. Like, if it's a physical thing.
Starts?
I think down one. Down a row.
Yeah, it's this is digital.
Isn't that it? Season one?
Yeah, you can buy the... Well, this is episode... No,
allegiancearts.com. Yeah, you go to the shop digital.
No, but wanted. We would have to say like, what's the collected?
Maybe I don't think they have the collected. I think it's
Because I don't want people to be downloading like multiple episodes either.
It'd be 20. Gonna... Yeah, because each issue is $5.
Yeah.
So I don't. You just you're getting each issue. You're buying each issue at that point.
Yeah. Yo, no say. And everybody kind of does. Everybody know that. Allegiance Arts is pretty much out of business. Everybody knows that, right?
I think they're.
I know
they're gonna
we do.
Their stuff. They're going to fulfill their stuff, but I don't know if they're doing anything more.
Yeah. So, which is unfortunate.
Yeah.
So, we're going to say no to that.
Well, again, they're having financial issues, and they got rid of all the team that they had, so it's now just the husband and the wife. So whatever they're doing really slow.
They're working pretty much to just. Finish the books, get it to print, and get it to the. I doubt they're going to do any overstock or anything like that. It's just going to be the minimum amount for.
Yeah.
Hello, Alyssa.
Yep. Do you know this human being? Or are you just saying hi?
Just saying hi.
Okay. Well, hello. So that may be a topic for another day. Because we have a full story now. They're going out of business. And that's based off, like Jav says, a Mike Barron tweet.
Yeah,
he said, hey, I have the Saints if you want a copy. And they're like, I know Jolly Green was in there. He was like, I'm a backer. De donde? And he was like, hey, they're pretty much shut down. And I was like, oh, pain. All right. So I think this is going to be the poll.
Sounds good.
Great.
All right. So this is the poll for the chat reads that will happen in May, and we'll determine the date right now. Well, after the poll is completed, I'm gonna say this one. Don't see the results. Get in there, chat.
If I have to.
Henry Bemis says, I think Mike didn't quite get the people didn't buy comics off the rack anymore, except maybe manga. And again, like the thing with manga is that it's the same size, like effectively the same size as a novel, as a paperback novel, right? So Walmart is used to carrying stuff like that. Like they're not used to carrying floppies anymore.
Yeah.
If they ever carried floppies. Omar Glitch says, they got bamboozled. They got more than bamboozled. Yeah. I mean,
sad story.
It is sad, like, especially when, because what it was like year and a half where Mitch was like, yeah, put my house up and did this and that, paid all my savings to like they went all in. So for them to be like, hey, we're going, you know, effectively.
Yeah. Then they lost the house.
Yes, that means like, oh my, like that is, hopefully this doesn't happen, but that makes people usually ripe for divorce. And I'm not trying to speak that negativity over their lives, but I understand what they're, well, not personally, and I've never been married, but like, I understand the danger that their relationship is in right now. And that's rough. Dojo Kun says, I actually look forward to finding the next issue of Allegiant Arts at Walmart. You looked forward to doing what was effectively the Easter egg hunt in your local Walmart to figure out where they put it.
Yeah, it was rough too.
Yeah, because I was like, every Walmart had it at a different place. It wasn't like uniformed at all. So will the latest Bass Reeves be fulfilled? Well, what do we always say here? Hopefully. Jab Styler's the usual manga is around 180 pages. Yeah, so like a typical kind of novel-ish size, depending on the size of the page.
Looks like we're getting into Bloodhunters.
Yep. So Omar Glitch says it'll either make them a stronger couple or as a couple or breaks them. Dang.
That could truly bring them together a little bit.
Yep. Stugel says, looking for Mitch's books was the last time I was in a Walmart. Dojo Kun said, there's only one Walmart within 50 miles off. Once I found it, it was found. LOL.
That being said, if they, you know, kind of go through hell and back to get these books fulfilled when they pretty much ended their company, would gain some respect from me, because most people would just say, sorry, we don't have the funds. That's it. We got to cut it down. Bye. And if they, you know, stay back to get this stuff out,
cut off the stand bags that are weighing them down.
That's a clean slate for me as far as I'm concerned.
All right. So it's looking like we're doing called the Wraith. Dang. Wrath of God 2, Electric Boogaloo, Bloodhunters. I don't know. Stat, why'd you let me type out the wrong?
I was just waiting for you to say Dank Hunters or something.
Okay. It's the Wrath of God. That's Bloodhunters. And then we'll do this right before the hiatus. So our hiatus will be the 25th. So we'll do this May 18th. I know a lot of you backed that book already. For the ones who haven't, hopefully you have enough time to obtain that book. All right. So that's poll number one. Poll number two is the Hillbilly Book Club. So what the Hillbilly Book Club is what we did with Dank Fang. We are reading a CG-er's past work. Same rules apply. It has to be readily available and also reasonably priced. I prefer not to chase floppies if you're thinking about doing a run. The preference is them being collected. If it's a annual or a giant. So if it's an annual, we'll count that. If it's like something, what was the one with Bane that we did, Bird?
That was a special style kind of thing, like a
what was it called? What was it? What's its birth certificate name? Yeah, the rat, like something like that, where it's like it's a one issue thing.
Prestige book.
Yes, like what the bird said, a prestige book. But readily available, no floppies, are no floppy runs. So I don't want to see this
Spider-Man 1-5.
Yeah. Okay, I remember this from last time. Lepresti, Wonder Woman, Conan. Okay, so I remember you said that the last time, and you're like, no, that's what it's called. And I was like, dope.
Oh, let me look something up, see if it's pretty available, because I got an idea.
Right. What's the, is it Batman that has, like, the grave on the cover and his nemesis and a very popular book? I remember it was recommended to me. I just can't think of what the title was. I got it.
A Batman Halloween?
Not the Long Halloween. It was,
She's talking about the shorter Halloween, yeah.
So, yeah. Jolly Green says no flop. Maroney says Vanessa wants it hard. I mean, if it's a hard cover, I would prefer that. But that's a personal preference.
Dark Knight Returns too much?
Huh?
Dark Knight Returns doesn't have anybody that was in CG.
Oh. Yeah. then what the hell am I thinking? I don't know. Okay, go ahead. Forget that. Scratch that. Rewind.
You could try Claw the Unconquered from Andy Smith and Chuck Dixon.
Okay.
Get Claw? Ready for 12-pack abs. But Claw the Unconquered.
Is it kind of like a Conan book?
Yeah, kind of like that. He's got this weird like hand that's like webbed and clawed and stuff. It's like Conan with a. It's an older property that they kind of brought back. It's pretty interesting stuff.
Chat. Amanda, I need spelling. It's not working. Unconquered. I know there's a Q in there.
U-A-O-N. Yep.
Q.
There it is.
There you go.
Oh, well, conk would be C.
Conquered.
Yes.
Where's the C?
Before the Q.
I think that's. I don't believe you.
That's it.
Paste.
Oh.
There's no damn C.
What are you talking about?
Spelled it correctly, Amanda.
There's a C before the Q.
There's no C before the Q.
Yes, damn. There is.
C-O-N-Q-U-E-R-E-D.
Yeah, C-O-N-Q. The C is before the Q.
Chat, you saw how I typed it in correctly, right? And then she was like, there's a C before the Q. You see that, chat? You see how she does this to me?
You see that?
Was it Batman Recipes? No, I don't know.
Maybe
it was Somebody's Revenge, but it doesn't have CG people in it. I think it was like Somebody's Revenge.
Although we couldn't do that anyways.
Yeah, I wasn't thinking.
So Carbon Art was like, are you talking about Batman Rest in Peace?
I want to say it's Revenge. That somebody, like the revenge of somebody.
Jolly Green says, I haven't gotten a side hug since the Obama administration. Oh, Jolly Green needs a hug. All right, what else, chat?
The Grave. No, I don't know. I don't think it's really ready available anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it is.
Is it? Let's do The Grave.
Because I let me
Amazon was where I got
$2.99 used, $7.99 new.
So
that sounds about right, Snuggy. Craven. I don't know if it's Craven the Hunter, but Craven I think was the nemesis that was in it.
All right. Anybody else? Chat. I'm about to look at you. I'm putting Amazon.com in one of my things. Vengeance of Bane. I dig you.
What about Planet Hulk?
Hold on.
It's $22.99 on eBay. Used and new, $5.
Just eBay? Or is it... How many copies does that seller have?
Yes.
Yes, Maromi, that's it. Craven's Last Hunt.
All right, so Dojo Kun says Spider.
You know, that's actually. They re-released that in an epic collection called Craven's Last Hunt. So it's like $25 to $30 for that and a bunch of other stories readily available.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's not a CG one, is it?
No, it's not, so you can use it.
Right.
But you can use Planet Hulk.
Okay.
Which is Lopresti.
Who is it?
Lopresti.
Oh,
was that did a bunch of art on that book.
All right, anybody else? Because if not, I'm pressing it. Who was The Grave by Daniel Fraga?
Mm-hmm.
All right, I am creating a poll.
Cool.
I have no feelings about this one. Let's see. Paste. Press it. Do it. Do it. Do it. I see there's Dan. It says Dan.
Da Frega.
It is Da Frega.
Well, wow, look at
in
this.
In his house, he's Da Frega.
I've never... Okay, there we go. I was going to say, I've never seen that before. It's just split. Whoa. This is a close one.
What, the pie?
Yeah.
Year of the rabbit, decade of the rabbit, century of the rabbit, bro.
It's all about the rabbit.
I am mentally just going to be surprised if I get Black Flag. Like, I...
Oh, shoot.
I just don't see it. There's a lot
the
of...
one that Vaughn had a hard time with?
I don't know that he did. I don't think I've ever...
I think
so.
I can't.
Really.
I think I want to say he mentioned that it was like, he didn't care for it. Planet Hulk. Ooh, Planet Hulk's up there, too. Either way, I mean, I'm happy.
The rabbit died. He's not dead. He's still alive. There's just a lot of stuff going on, and I do not foresee that book.
Well, we might have a runoff.
Chat, don't do that to me. I still have I have two Sandwich Saturday polls to do, and hopefully you guys have put sandwiches into X gonna give it to you.
I have seen Lepresti do some, I don't know if it's sketches or shared pages or something with Wonder Woman on Twitter, and he makes a nice Wonder Woman.
Yeah, he did that with Gail Simone and then Greg Pak with Planet Hulk.
I'm sorry, I'm checking the status of Sandwich Saturday, and I saw Judgment from Amanda.
16 Uh-oh. Votes. Of course you see Judgment from me.
It's okay. She judged me too.
She was like, this is diabetes. And I was
16
like, 16 exactly.
votes. There's like 30 people in the chat who
yeah,
haven't voted.
Get out, Pace.
The other 14 people are like, run off.
All right. So why is Black Flag so late? I don't get it. And I really like that a lot. So
lots
objectively. So objectively. Frega based his production speed off the last time he was on a deadline for a comic, which was aggressive. Because because it was April with a January ship date. So that was an aggressive timeline to begin with. And he was basing stuff on like, well, I did this in the past. I'm like, you care too much. It's your baby. He's had a whole bunch of medical issues. He still has a day job. Because we at least know about a couple of kidney stones. Basically just he didn't understand his production speed for a crowdfunder. Because it's one, and it's something that Ethan has said before on stream, and I'm like, damn, you're really not selling crowdfunding right now. But Ethan was talking about like him hiring artists to do stuff and like how to get things done, you know, at a reasonable time. And he's like, you don't pay the artist up front. You produce something and I cut a check. And I was like, god damn, we give you the money up front. This was not a good sales tactic, sir. You were just not aware at the moment when you said that. So that's part of it. And it's unfortunate because like when all of this dramatic stuff started happening, like, bro, I have missed 2019 Dan Frega so much this year. Because that 2019-2020 Dan Frega, that was a mystical kind of dude. And now we know he bleeds like a man, and it's unfortunate. All right. Chat, I need whoever has the reserve.
Who has not voted.
Yeah, whoever has the reserve vote. I need you to break up this tie. So, and then Matt says, Dan moved and had COVID, and yeah, like, there's a lot of going on, and that's probably not even and that's only the stuff we see via stream. So like his family definitely knows what's going on. He knows what's going on.
Oh, it's a four-way tie?
We're not doing that. It's not a four-way tie, because I don't think
Drop it into Twitter.
Hold on.
First one to take it.
I know, right? Did I vote? I think I voted.
I think you did.
I think I voted for that. You already voted on this poll. We're about to put it on Twitter.
Do it. First one to take it.
And we're putting this on Twitter. Break the tie. See, now we're tied again. Don't do this to me, chat.
On Twitter too. Okay.
There you go.
Did it go?
I put it up.
All right.
Stats just becoming an alcoholic in the background.
Oh, dang these virgin alcoholic drinks.
I know, right? Jav Styler says Fractober. The first one was so, dude, that was, oh. Don't get me upset.
Thanks for voting, Joseph. You tied it.
So let me go refresh.
Hey.
Oh, hey, Batman vs Spider-Man. Grab
Nolan. There we are.
Okay, so it is by Graham Nolan, right, chat? Before you got have me a liar.
Refresh.
Let me refresh. I have live results.
Oh, okay.
Shouldn't need a refresh.
Sorry, that was hilarious.
You freaking had me spelling Concord all jacked up. There's a C before the Q. Like, how much
there before the Q? There is a C before the Q.
How much before the Q? There's his name. Outstanding. All right, so we're gonna stop don't forget it now.
Don't forget to clear the poll. You don't want people. We put it under Twitter.
Oh, that is true. Hold on. Can I even go back? Put onto Twitter. Oh, I don't think there's one. Wait, let me see. And delete. Okay. Delete successfully. What was
it? Did it end up being Graham?
Yeah, we're doing Graham Nolan, Batman, Spider-Man.
Awesome. I've got that in an old trade.
All right. Man and Spider-Man. All right, let's go.
Images.
Stop sharing.
Oh, we got this week winner, and then we're doing the month winner?
Yes, hold on. So June 22nd will be the hiatus because I'm going to that music festival again. So do you want to do it before? You know, let's do it after. So that's going to be June 29th. So yay, I'm gonna have to go fix my PowerPoint. That's all. So as a reminder, we're doing Wraith of God 2, Electric Boogaloo, also known officially by its birth certificate name, as Wraith of God Blood Hunters. We're doing that on May 18th. And then we're doing Batman and Spider-Man with Graham Nolan art on June 29th. Hiatuses will be May 25th for Memorial Day weekend and June 22nd for the first day of summer for Vanessa. I'm going to go watch Jason Derulo.
Send that to my email, V. What,
Jason Derulo?
The date she's talking about.
I'll also put it, I'll put it in the writer's room and I'll also make a community post. All right, now we move into what everybody is the favorite part of everybody's of this show. Most serious thing we do here is this here Sandwich Saturday. Okay, share our screen. Share
more serious screen. Than a bag of dicks.
I almost want to fire Amanda, but I can't be mad at her on that one. It is very serious. So hold on. So Sandwich Saturday winner. All right, so whoever wins the next poll will have to 1v1 Snuggles' Buffalo Chicken Panini.
I would have argued with her last statement, but that would have been a fallacy.
All right, let me go check. Rats, I voted for someone else to do it. LOL. Joseph said he voted. Reserve vote used for evil. Let's see here. You doubted Murray? Yes, I doubt people all the time. That's what I do professionally, is doubt people. I got to go to my Zazen session. What's a Zazen session? Is that where you Zazen? Like, what happens? Hail all, hail the chat. Well, hail to you too. Jade Dollar won the bunny suit. LOL, that's a 27-year-old book. I doubt we'll be able to get that one. Will we be able to get that one?
Seated meditation.
Had me going to Batman and Spider-Man. Oh, look, it popped up right away. Bird, did you lie to me about getting this?
I didn't talk about the Batman Spider-Man one. I don't know who.
Okay, so
that one, I think up. That was OJB, wasn't it?
The couple that I said the Planet Hulk for 22 or less. Some of them are $5, and then the Cull or Claw, which is like 15 to 10 or something. So those were mine. So I don't know. Okay. I just came back in the room.
No, let's see here. On eBay, paperback. What the shit? $15. No, like,
what was the next one up from that then? If that's,
well, I mean, it's deleted now. No, eBay has it.
Never mind. Oh, never mind. It would have been, well, it would have been Wonder Woman, Lopresti's Wonder Woman, I think.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's the next one down?
Yeah. Yeah, they have it. Oh, they have it. Very good. Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, then I just blame the chat on that. It says paperback. Why does it say paperback? Oh, it must be a trade.
It's probably in paperback.
Let me see.
Yeah, on eBay, that's $100 used. Oh, wait, that's the other one. Where's the...
details. Well, either that or we're going to the high seas. Well, then I'll just blame the chat there, Jav. Of course, just find it on the high seas.
Oh, wait. Oh, never mind. Yeah. On eBay, $100 new, or you can pay $50 used.
Yeah. I found one Batman Spider-Man for 15.
It's Spider-Man, Batman, Spider-Man.
What part of readily available is, you know what, we're at this point, it is what it is, chat. We're not running this back again. Either we'll talk about this.
Shadow's running the show by himself because Vanessa and I can't get it.
I'm the only one that's got it.
Like, Shadow's about to take pictures of all the things. Like $15. All right. So it is at this point, it is what it is. Next, hold on. So I have to put a note for next quarter about the definition of readily available. Because that's when we were going to have the reminder of it.
Is it the New Age Dawning, the J.M. Demetrius book?
It's going to be J.M. DeMatteis, Graham Nolan, Carl Kiesel. Yep.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Because I see A Books has 3 available for $15 with shipping of $375. So I suppose you dig, you'll find it.
Yeah, if you dig, you find it. Let's go. Hold on.
Well, they're re-releasing them all in an omnibus very soon, but it won't be before the chat hits, and it's going to be like $60 to $80 for the whole omnibus. Yeah. So.
Hold on, I'm buying my $15 copy. I don't want
to get in.
Getting it in. Place my order, bitches.
That's not the right one, Jojo Kun, on Amazon. That's I think you're looking at a different. There's 2 different versions. There's two of them. One of them is like Tom Grummet or something like that.
So wait,
I think I did see one on Amazon.
Is it this one stat that I'm sharing?
That one, yes.
Okay, so this one, chat. And look, ShopRail, you have a new order. All right, $10 on eBay. So it'd be this one. It'd be that one.
Yeah.
Check your LCS. We're trying not to check. Not everybody has those. Omer glitch.
I'm not even sure where mine is.
Mine's literally down the road. It's less than half a mile away. It's bad.
Oh, no. No, he's right. There is... I see one listing on eBay here for $15.
Okay. So, well, get it while the getting is good.
All half right. price book. Go figure. Yeah.
Go figure.
You just got to look at a couple of different listings, but yeah.
You have to freaking search. It got imported then. I only see a Brazilian one on German eBay. Maybe it's better in Brazilian Portuguese. Who knows? All right. So getting back to the Sandwich Saturday.
One for 33. So yeah, okay.
Yep. So back to Sandwich Saturday. Whoever wins this week has to 1v1 Snuggie against his Buffalo Chicken Panini to win Sandwich of the Month. So let's go over here. Sandwich Saturday. Hopefully I'm not the only one who put in a sandwich. Although I would kind of like my chances with diabetes mellitus. All right. So Stippling Vaughn has put, I proudly present the Longhorn Spicy Chicken Bite, Parmesan Cheese. Wait, Chicken Bite?
Is that a chicken nugget in there? I approve.
Yeah.
A chicken. Long, well, at least she tried. Here you go. A chicken nugget sandwich, like a legitimate chicken nugget. So I had an ice cream. So this is from... But one of my friends is leaving the state of Idaho to return to Washington, to return to her homeland, the place of her birth, where she was born, her birth. So we went out to try this place, Yo Nuts, and this is an ice cream sandwich in a donut. Was it delicious? Yes. Did I get a sugar high of a 3-year-old? I sure the hell did. But that's
so. Wait, what is it? You got two donuts with some ice cream in
the middle? It's a donut. So this was the s'more, obviously donut. So you have a donut, vanilla ice cream. You have the chocolate glaze. You have some marshmallows.
It's only one donut.
Yes, cut in half. So it is a sandwich because we have bread filling bread. Is she moving to Eastern or Western? She's moving back to the Seattle area. I'm not doxing my friend. And then she's like, I'm not yelling. Yes, you are. Jim Cox says, Vanessa is disqualified. How dare you, sir? All right. So that's it. And then Amanda put Black Forest ham, cooked ham. Okay, so is there two types of hams? Is that what you're trying to say here?
Yes.
So Black Forest ham, cooked ham, provolone cheese, and marinated artichoke hearts on a herbed garlic bread roll. I'm not even mad at you. There's the artichoke heart. Just saying hi.
Yeah.
I'm not mad. That would be something I make. I'm not mad at it.
And what it was the all shit baked is this? In the oven.
Oh, okay, this is obviously not an approved sandwich.
No, but I thought it was funny, so I shared it.
New Zealand and then Spain. So those, does that cover? It does. That covers our sandwiches. Do we have this set? Okay, so the last sandwich Saturday was the ninth. All right, so Dojo Kun has Atlantic salmon with ginger, brown sugar, soy, butter pads on 12 grain bread, and he made it himself. Oh, Deanna was out of town. No. All right, and that was the last one. So those are the sandwiches for the week. Let me go make this poll. I'm going to need you guys to filibuster, please, and thank you.
Oh, boy, more polls. You excited?
There's three sandwiches. Yeah. How long is it going to take you?
Well, no, but anyways. There's one, two, three, four sandwiches. And I
need I forgot about Stippling. Sorry.
That's way different than three.
Yes, the four is definitely different than three.
I got because through this. I thought maybe I shouldn't show my face for this chat. But I said, no, I'm gonna take my lumps.
I appreciate it. Now you
I just want to take a look at my channel real quick. Oh, shoot, everybody unsubscribed. Just kidding.
I mean, sorry. It looks like a bird.
Like a bird, yeah. That's right, yeah. Exactly like a bird.
Like a bird.
I dive bombed. I got a few people. And
honestly, it wasn't the worst beat in the world. It was just ridiculous.
No, it was ridiculous.
No, we treated it like a comedy and had a fun time with it.
That was hilarious.
It was. It was funny. Come on now.
So funny. So who do you guys think is going to win? Electioneering.
Actually, I have a question about Vanessa's sandwich. So drizzled chocolate, is it one of those like comes out liquid, but as it sits there, it hardens?
I did not watch the kid make it.
So was the chocolate still gooey, or was it like a magic shell?
No, it was gooey. It was gooey.
I think it'd be better as like a magic shell had that little, you know, crunch to it.
The crunch to it
has that weird aftertaste to it, though.
Think so?
Yeah. Unless there's like a difference between the kind you buy in a store versus like, say, some crazy restaurant magic or whatever like that. I always found it had like an odd aftertaste to it.
Well, I suppose it has to be some finagling to make shit, you know, the liquid. And then once it gets to the cold air or whatever, it freezes.
Mm-hmm. It's true.
Oh.
Did you even talk about that tweet that I had where they put bread on exact opposite sides of the earth, so therefore it made a sandwich? Like two men in New Zealand and Spain have created an earth sandwich by placing
I figured everybody who's here on this show can at least read English.
No.
Well, like, okay, the people they want you to who are read in English. The chat, the people in the chat who are active in the chat, like typing and typing words and shit, that they speak English and they read English. So they could have read that. I was just like, oh, I mean, I read it when you posted it. I was like, oh, that's interesting, but I'm not going to put that on the freaking poll. I mean, you're trying to, I mean, who, I don't even know these gentlemen's names. Do you want me to put it in a poll? Like two dudes.
I don't know. I don't want you to put it in the
poll.
Who made
an earth, I just, earth sandwich.
A little bit more attention. Their feet was very tough to create.
What do you mean their feet is very tough to create? Everybody got feet.
We got enough beef here for plenty of sandwiches.
Everybody has feet, Amanda.
Wow.
Michael DJ, I like crunch. Give me the texture in my mouth.
Are you the type of person to put like chips in your sandwich sometimes? You take
no,
like,
I don't. But I put in nuts in my meatloaf.
Okay.
Oh my God.
I mean, I hate all
onions
meatloaf,
in my tuna fish. I like
nuts in our meatloaf. That's all
nuts
I need to know.
Nuts in my meatloaf. Yes. I know it's odd, but it's good, people.
All right, so let's go see. We got some electioneering in the chat. The salmon sandwich is the best. Ignore all the rest because he ate it. I mean, which is fair. Like, of course it's the best. That's the one you ate. Maromi says that doesn't work on flat earth. Amanda likes that hard solidified chemical shell on her chocolate. Noted. Can I make a sandwich with cheese as the bread? No.
Well, that's, you know, that's like one of those Atkins sandwiches.
Well, let me see. You can. I'm sure you have the ability to do so.
So you'd disqualify it if it was like two pieces of lettuce and some meat in between?
I mean, I eat that type of sandwich, but I'll get disqualified on Sandwich Saturday.
Interesting.
You got some more electioneering?
Yeah.
That's tacos. What you said. Why aren't they in here? Put something in my mouth. If you could get a hard shell and another hard shell and put the tacos in between, I will allow it for voting.
What if you crack the hard shell so it's got two half shells and then put the stuff in between, eat it like that?
So it's still two separate pieces of corn, mm-hmm. of corn hard shell.
Yep.
With filling in the middle.
Yep.
So we have a carbohydrate filling carbohydrate.
Yeah.
I would allow it.
What if I cut like
you would have to show the break though. What?
Cut a soft shell in half, you know what I mean? Like with a pizza cutter or something, and then like put some stuff in between there.
Yeah, that's a freaking who put the quilladilla? I think Vaughn put in the quilladilla.
Flatbread sandwich.
He just made sure, like, hey, there's two tortillas, so like this it's not a quesadilla, it's a quilladilla. It qualifies as a sandwich. And I was like, I'll allow it.
Great.
See here. Amanda should have mentioned her shaved legs and her sheets. I don't think that has anything to do with these sandwiches. Sisson says
my ham was pretty smooth in that sandwich.
Did you shave your hand?
I did shave my ham.
Oh, I thought you did your hand. Oh no, Vanessa's gonna die. She's not gonna be able to close down the screen. I said hand.
The bird is like, did you shave your knuckle hairs? And she's like, I shaved that pig. Pig was
I didn't say knuckle hairs.
Oh, because you said hand.
Yes. I was just wondering, like
shave my ham.
She like get into like one of those laser rooms and just get like just hold herself out and just everything's gone or but then she's like, no. See, this is about the sandwiches. Ham.
All right. So Overglitch says, do two pizzas slapped together count? Yes.
Ooh.
Barobi says, yes, because you have a carbohydrate, a filling, a carbohydrate.
I think I just might
two
have to
bread,
get myself
two breaded cutlets with bacon in the middle. No. Because the chicken, so breaded describes is a adjective describing the noun of chicken. So it's two chicken cutlets. And also the word cutlet describes chicken. So it's two chickens with a bacon. That's a protein. I need a carb.
What about two pieces of steak with stuff in the middle?
Then that's just meat.
Well, see, the steak ate the carbs. It's in there. But
that's a protein.
Yeah. That's...
I don't care what the previous dead animal ate.
You're not allowing the gluten-free people to join in.
There is gluten-free bread, and you know,
it's disgusting.
Jim Cox will give you a recommendation.
They would rather eat just the meat.
If you want to use rice patties or whatever.
What about the people that don't like seed oils? Well, there's a lot of seed oils in bread, you know.
Well, I mean, I guess they just can't enter Sandwich Saturday. What can I tell you? The standard is the standard. Carbohydrate, filling, carbohydrate.
Sandwich kept.
Now, if you want to make an argument that a vegetable is a carbohydrate, which is the argument that you're going to make, then I will clarify it to starch.
So what about those? What about like they use potato starch? Or they use cauliflower.
Bread?
Cauliflower, you know, they make like cauliflower like stuff.
I mean, if you want to, I'm gonna tell you that's not.
I wouldn't. I mean, it's.
Well, I mean, cauliflower
maybe
bread.
There's a lurker going. I'm not gonna stop you. If only I could get into this, but somebody's like nobody's speaking up for me. Someone that doesn't eat bread. And then I'm speaking up for him. I said, join this sandwich
Steve.
Saturday, I says.
Well, I mean, sandwich ice cream better not win or it's rigged. Oh, God. Vanessa's doing her best step. Oh, okay. Let me click what in the shit is going bow to my will. Here we go. What else do you shave? Well, I'm perfecting my back glutes muffaella.
Huh? I feel like she wasn't being stippling so much as Leo gets from Lethal Weapon. Whatever.
See, Moromi's like, breading is a carb. No, the breading is adverb or adjective describing the noun of chicken.
Well, now, hold on now. If you have just the breading and then the chicken and then the breading, like, isn't that just a sandwich in and of itself?
Oh,
it's surrounded by the breading. So,
do we need to pray, chat, about the legalism?
We're trying to help you with the filibustering.
On this sandwich Saturday?
You know, we're helping you with that filibustering.
All right. So Jim Cox says that he would allow it. I made roast beef for the first time this week, and I need to make a Philly for next Sat. Please do. I'm getting called a sandwich Nazi. Okay, sandwiches that come apart in space. Still, sandwiches that come apart in space. Are you going on SpaceX, Shelby? Like, are you going to experience zero gravity where your sandwich is coming apart? Mm-hmm. Because the effect of the earth on your body and on the sandwich is negated because you're in the atmosphere. Cauliflower pizza crust was great once, LOL. The keto bread I used to eat is not gluten-free. Well, there's gluten-free bread. Let's see here. So ramen bread sandwich, I would allow it.
Gotta get those college kids in there.
Yep, sandwich fascists. Shelby says, I'm rich, so yes. No, they would have to be connected by gravity of the earth. Because if you have the gravity of the moon or something, you're just showing off now. All right. Chat, I need you to break the tie. I don't have to win. I really don't. But can you just at least break the tie? There's enough. I have one more poll after this.
Wow.
I'll even do NPR voice if somebody would just break the tie.
That's real
just
sweet.
Just go in there. Go in there, lurkers. We have 13 votes. There's 25 of you in the chat. 24 of you because I'm in the chat.
Hi, lurkers. Break the tie.
Shelby, break the tie. Connected by a toothpick. See, why? See, now I know you're busting my tails. I voted for salmon to tie it. How dare you? Just voted. Did you vote for artichoke? Is that what you voted for?
I'm laughing. I was gonna say if it was just one of the ones down below. Doesn't help.
I win. Hashtag rigged. Oh,
she calls it out. Yes, it was.
Hashtag rigged. Oh my goodness. So now Snuggless. Oh my goodness. Straw pool. Let me go rock this pool. Oh, hurting my feelings, chat. I'm hungry. All right, so sandwich of the month. Poor poll, chat. I don't need all these options. So it's Snuggless, Buffalo Chicken Panini. Mm-hmm. And me. Ice cream sandwich using a donut.
It's like some MacGyver sandwich making right there.
Pull. You see me vote. So you can't be like, oh, you're just going to go and vote for yourself so you can win.
She's going to hold her vote in case there's a...
No, I already voted. So let me get the poll in the chat.
so that they can ignore it, right? Is that what we're doing?
Yep.
Oh, okay. We'll vote.
There you go.
Okay. So all right, this is where I'm supposed results. To vote?
Yep.
You think?
Hashtag rigged. There it is.
All right, I suppose I should
vote as often as you can. This is for sandwich of the month and to secure a space for sandwich of the year. Amanda, did you win February?
Amanda's I do not here. Remember. No, I'm here. I don't remember.
Okay, I'm going to have to go make that PowerPoint again. I know Stippling Vaughn is January because everybody was just
sleeping.
Well, no, because January was super, super dramatic this year. I'm sure I can find out who won February. Jim Clark says, I gotta vote for Snuggie Jr. for once, just to fight the man or woman.
Oh.
Then Cicero says, come on, donuts. Sorry, Snugs. Andrew Curry says, I vote for Snuggie because it's smiling at me. Quiet Red Media just
hello, everybody.
Yeah, at the end of the show, but welcome. All right, Snuggie Jr. is taking a little bit of a lead. We got 14 votes and 27 in the chat. Go ahead and vote. Get up in here.
Mm-hmm.
We'll give you a minute and a half starting now. I lied. You'll get 2 minutes. It makes it easier for me. This show has an ending. Yes, it's going to end in about 3 minutes.
I hope this show has an ending.
You'll be hearing like, dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun. Just ignoring the fact that it was a tie. It wasn't a tie when I freaking shut it down. So there it is.
Wow, it has been a 3-hour show. Look at that.
Yeah, wait. This is supposed to be a 2 to 2.5 hour show.
Hot diggity dog.
And Dojo's like justice for Dojo. It makes sense. It's like a nickname, Dojo. You can't do it for yourself. Somebody has to do it for you. All right. So you guys have... Let's go. Excuse me. 1 more minute left.
Yes.
Matt says, Snuggie sandwich looks like a Muffet, so it got my vote. Fair enough. I have the screenshots. I don't care. Chad is like, Vanessa, you have become a sandwich fascist, a sandwich Nazi. And I'm going to say on today, chat, it's a 3-hour show.
You were supposed to be the chosen one.
I was supposed to be the one. Who let the chat just do whatever? Chat, we don't got time for a 4-hour show. I'm hungry. We hit 3 hours. I'm starting to get cranky. Amanda's about to get sleepy. Bird is going to start drawing. Snuggie's like 3 to 3.5 hours in standard time. No, 2 to 2.5. We need 3 hours to fully
that. They love you.
Dank Fang. To fully cover Dank Fang. Quiet Media is a savage Nazi. Oh, Vanessa has the high ground. And Matt says, you're welcome, Snuggless. And the winner for this month, the sandwich of the month, is Snuggless. He has won.
Congrats.
That is not a one. I don't want to know about your post engagements. I'm not mad, but, you know, sandwich of the month. Apply. So, Snugglish, you have now secured yourself one entry into the sandwich of the year for 2024. Congratulations. All right, chat. So that is it for us. We're going into hiatus. Please be good to each other. Or at least stretch for the combat to come. Because who knows what's going to happen on hiatus. Can EVS send Vanessa some Mickey D's or Taco Bell? No.
That'd be pretty funny.
That would be pretty funny. All right. So we will see you back in April. So next week's hiatus. So April the 6th will be our next show. Be good during hiatus, but we'll see you around in the chats.
Yep. Later.
And then go find a Cindy Crawford, and we'll see you in April chat. Oh, wait, before I go, moderators, please put links to any CG shows that are happening right now or that will happen in the next couple hours. We appreciate you. See you in April.
の体は水冷です。